From Memorial Stadium on the campus of Bakersfield College, the Condorstown Outdoor Classic. Your Bakersfield Condors versus the Ontario Reign. Sponsored by Three-Way Chevrolet and Bakersfield College. Now, let's go to the ice.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to a special, exciting edition of Bakersfield Condors hockey action as tonight the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank has finally arrived on the campus of Bakersfield College here at Memorial Stadium. Ryan Holt along with the Kevin Bartle, your broadcast team for the evening. We're live on KGET.com, KGET17, and also AHLLive.com. Ryan Holt with Kevin Bartle. The Condors and the Ontario Reign meeting outdoors, the ninth ever AHL Outdoor Classic, and it's going to be a dandy here on the campus of Memorial Stadium, here on the campus of Bakersfield College at Memorial Stadium. Barts, a lot of work has gone into this. There's been a lot of buildup over the last 6 months. We've had 3 weeks of outdoor skating, outdoor fun here in Bakersfield, and now finally to play some hockey out here.
This game is over a year in the making, so it's taken a lot of work and a lot of effort from a lot of people to get to this point. And both teams are really excited. I saw them coming down the hill for warm-ups. They were out there 10 minutes early waiting for the walk down to the ice, so everybody wants to play this game.
A fantastic evening last night to Wayne Gretzky and Luke Robitaille captaining two alumni celebrity teams. It was a perfect evening here in Condorstown.
Yeah, it really was. It was a great night for hockey. The fans were loving it. The alumni were loving it. The celebrities were loving it. It was just a fun night overall, and great to see thousands of people here in this stadium getting a chance to witness hockey outside in Bakersfield for the first time.
I want to welcome in the third member of our broadcast team. You know him well on KGET17. That, of course, is it Jason Galvin. Galvin will be ringside throughout the night. Jason, good evening. Welcome to the Outdoor Classic.
And good evening, everybody. Ryan, Kevin, thanks so much. Good to have you here down ringside. And the one thing that we're keeping an eye on right now here is your weather. So I want to show you guys, before we get into the hockey aspect of things here, what the future cast looks like here. Of course, this game's been delayed a little bit, so the rain obviously having an effect, but it's not raining right now, just a really light drizzle. And it does look like we're in pretty good shape here for the next couple of hours. There's a ridge of rain that could just kind of bend right around Memorial Stadium here, and wouldn't that be nice? Hey, a big night for everybody here. The Condors have been preparing for this for months as a team, and even though they just started focusing on this game this week, it's been in the back of everybody's mind for a long time. We had a chance to catch up with Condors head coach Jerry Fleming about an hour and a half ago to talk about tonight's game.
Well, it's going to be fun. It's an exciting event. You know, the guys are excited to play, but at the end of the day, it's important that we get the 2 points here tonight.
What's the biggest factor of the win in this game?
Our forecheck. We've got to establish a strong forecheck out and get on their D and manage the puck, especially through the neutral zone.
What about playing through weather?
Both teams have to play through it, so we'll do our best.
All right, good luck,
great. Thank you.
Jerry Fleming, head coach of the Condors, optimistic about tonight's game. Ryan, Kevin, we're ready to go.
We're looking forward to it here on the KGET. It's going to be a great one, the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank. We're going to send it to a break. When we come back, we'll get the walkouts, we'll get the national anthem, get the goaltending matchup as well. We'll have Laurent Brossoit versus Jack Campbell tonight, Condors in Ontario. And we'll step out, take a quick timeout. When we come back, walkouts, anthem. We're going to drop the puck. It's the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic.
We're going to play hockey.
Presented by Mission Bank. Don't go anywhere. On KGET 17.
The Condorstown Outdoor Classic.
Welcome back to the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank. Ryan Holta with Kevin Bartle, the third member of our broadcast crew. There's none other than Jason Galvin. He's ringside, and he's got the goaltending matchup before tonight's contest.
Well, guys, getting ready for the team to walk down here. Let's take a look at your goalie matchups here for the night. Laurent Brossoit will be in goal for the Bakersfield Condors, starting his fifth out of six contests here. Five starts in the last six games for Brossoit. He's 7-8-3 on the year, a 2.75 goals against average. Jack Campbell in net for the Ontario Reign tonight. His 14th consecutive start for Campbell. He has a record of 14-3-2 on the season. Ultra impressive, but his goals against average, 2.70, very similar to Brossoit. And check out the save percentage numbers, both at 908. So the record's vastly different, but the play on the ice has been very close between Laurent Brossoit and Jack Campbell. Kevin, Ryan.
Thank you very much, Jason. Well, I mean, what a spectacle here out at Bakersfield College Memorial Stadium. Thank you so much for joining us. Ryan Holt with the Kevin and Bartle. The Condors getting set to hit the ice. Ontario has hit the ice. Now, Barts, Condors played in one of these last year. They practiced on this ice yesterday. Ontario, the first time that they saw this ice surface, this stadium, was about, three hours ago.
Right, and, you know, every team has to do what they feel is right for their own team. Why they didn't skate out here is anybody's guess. But nonetheless, both teams are fired up to be here. And, you know, tonight's an important 2 points as well. It's not just about a fun night here. They need this win. The Condors need a win.
A note on the Condors lineup. Anton Lander called up earlier in the week. Taylor Beck is back in the lineup for the Condors. Reigning AHL player of the month. He's been fantastic for Bakersfield this year.
Yeah, he really is. I mean, he's kind of been Mr. Everything. His points per game average has been fantastic. Space it out over a full season. You're talking about a 90 to 100 point season for Beck. At the time of his recall, he was leading the American Hockey League in scoring. He still leads the Condors in scoring, and he's still very much in play, even though he missed a couple of weeks.
Condors are just hitting the ice in front of a raucous crowd here at Memorial Stadium. What do you think about the jerseys tonight, Bart? It's going old school with a little leather classic and cream look.
Yeah, I love it, and but definitely not old school, as the Condors wearing three different styles of jersey here tonight. So we're going to mix it up a little bit, and hopefully the fans get a kick out of it.
The Condors will wear three different jerseys. They're all the same base, different crest. The reason for that, going to raise a lot of money for local charities here in Bakersfield. You get to wear three different jerseys. That's three different sets of jerseys, and a lot more people going home with game-worn jerseys from the Outdoor Classic, all for a great cause.
Yeah, it's great. Everybody's going to have a good time here tonight, and the rain is held off here in time to get this thing started, so let's have some fun.
So we're going to send it down for the anthem here in a Condorstown and get set for puck drop here in a Bakersfield. And don't go anywhere. It's the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic national anthem from a Memorial Stadium.
Soars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets rang, the bombs bursting.
One, rain has not dampened the spirits of this crowd here tonight. The Condors and the Ontario Rain live from Bakersfield College Memorial Stadium. It's a three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank. Nice to have you along here this evening. The Condors will skate left to right across your television monitors. Here this evening, they are in the home cream jerseys tonight. Ontario in the road blacks. They are donning the old school jerseys similar to the ones Wayne Gretzky wore back in the early 90s in the black and silver era. Jordan Osterley is back with the Condors. He will start this evening on the blue line, paired with Mark Fay, Joey Lalegia, Jajar Kara. Up front with the Patrick Russell. For Ontario, McDermott and Ledoux on the blue line. Andrew Crescenzi, Brett Sutter, and Mike Amadio up front. This place ready to erupt. Jack Campbell to the net to our right. Laurent Bressois down to our left. Your officials tonight is assigned by the American Hockey League. Referees of Evgeny Romasko and Zach Wiebe. Linesman James Parker and Brent Tubbs. Ontario right to left. Condors left to right here this evening. Game time temperature, 54 degrees. And a light, and I mean light, Bakersfield drizzle for puck drop.
This is the kind of rain we're used to seeing in Bakersfield.
Yes.
Not what has consistently fallen upon our Winterfest over the last couple of weeks. Nonetheless, we're ready to go. Certainly nothing that they can't play through.
Puck is down. A game is on in the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic. Is off and running. Ontario controls the opening faceoff of the right wing. Knocked down by Mark Frazier. Played up by Ledoux. Turned over. Condors carry in. Lalegi gets through the slot. Ledoux sends to the corner. And on the forecheck goes Patty Russell, the native of Holte, Denmark. Puck flip blank to the ice. Jordan Osterley back to retrieve. Osterley spent what he called 36 hours in the great city of Boston, Massachusetts. Osterley did. On a recall with the Edmonton Oilers earlier this week, he arrived back in Bakersfield just in time for his second Condorstown outdoor game and his third all-time. He also played in one at Western Michigan. Ontario with the puck in the neutral zone. It's gloved down there by Griffin Reinhart. Reinhart at his own blue line. Condors that come up the right wing where it's a knockdown by McDermott. McDermott bounces up to the neutral zone. Condors try and force a turnover to do so. Here's Slepyshev dropping. Great circle shot and a save made off the effort from Taylor Back. Take a look at the captain's matchup tonight. Ryan Hamilton on the Condors side. Vincent Loverdy on the Ontario side. Loverdy recently named to the American Hockey League All-Star Classic later this month. Ryan Hamilton, 10th year Condor. This is his third AHL outdoor game. He's one of just two members to play in three AHL outdoor games. Pass in front, deflected off Hamilton's stick. It'll go length to the ice, and you hear from the linesman from our great Mike's on the ice. Speed icing call coming up against Ontario. 18:48 to go, opening period. Now that the hoopla is over of introductions, we can settle in and play some hockey here, Mike.
And if there's a scoring opportunity right on the doorstep, you can bet that number 12 for the home team is in the middle of it. Indeed, he was. Ryan Hamilton, the vet, he knows exactly where to go to score the goals. Nearly put one in there to give the Condors the lead.
We'll take a look at the players to watch. Our next whistle, right point Fane, shot deflected in front by Beck. Mark Fane has played six games with the Condors over 2 years. Down for the Edmonton Oilers. He's played in two outdoor games with Bakersfield.
Yeah, how about that?
Fane also playing in the one at Yankee Stadium. The Stadium Series game between the Devils and the New York Rangers. How about that venue? Slepyshev on the forecheck. Puck knocked down. Off the stick of Sean Backman. Backman 18 points in 28 games with Ontario. Puck over the blue line. Shot in wide of Bressois. It'll go up and over the glass and out of play. Take a look at the players to watch tonight for the Condors. The return of Taylor Beck back from the Edmonton Oilers. Beck with 30 points in 19 games of this season. And on the Ontario side, Michael Mercier had practiced the last 3 days, but 21 points in 27 games. He's a gamer. 10 goals on the season. First shot of the storied hockey program, the University of Wisconsin. Condors has come through the neutral zone. Off a face-off win. Puck flips, and something we normally don't have to worry about. The puck goes out of play. And right past our broadcast location. You gotta retrieve the puck.
That's a souvenir. We're taking it.
Yeah, we're taking the puck. There it is.
That's a souvenir.
We're holding on to it.
First one out of
play. Good call, Bart. That's why you're the vice president.
You know.
Let's go. Condors the chance from the over 13,000 in attendance tonight. Tickets move quick. Not many deterred by the rain here today. Condors hoping not to be deterred by the rain. R-E-I-G-N.
And this is a big challenge for the Condors. The rain have really been hot. Campbell has been a workhorse for this team and has led them to the top spot in the conference. Best record in the conference, second overall win percentage in the entire American Hockey League.
Campbell is a 14th straight start, 14-3-2 on the season, second in wins in the AHL. Bakersfield, the neutral zone, and pitching it forward. Brayden Christopher with Yuri Selina. Christopher on the forecheck, Selina down the left wing. D to D, Ontario will post up, and an outlet feed up the right wing for Michael Latta. Latta played in the Winter Classic, as that one will go for an icing against Ontario. 17-14 to go in the first. Played in the Winter Classic last year on New Year's Day with the Washington Capitals at Nationals Park.
Ain't too bad. You know, both teams are really jazzed up for this game. The Condors, more than anybody, want to come up with a win. They're not overly concerned with Rain's record right now. This is 2 points that they want in the standings and in front of a big crowd here today.
Faceoff to the right of Jack Campbell. Condors have sent out the Kara line. Kara, LaLegia, and Russell. You're just joining us as Condors season. Joey LaLegia started the year as a defenseman, has played forward on the wing of Jajar Kara in each of the last of five contests. Shots are 2-1 Bakersfield early on. They've controlled the opening of 4 minutes of play here at Memorial Stadium. Ressois will leave it, post it up in the left wing corner. And Mark Frazier will dipsy do back behind his own net. Albert pass for Kara through center ice. Knocking it down is Frazier. Kara goes in on the forecheck down the right wing. Puck along the back wall. On the forecheck comes Patty Russell. Russell left wing boards. It's LaLegia knocking it down. Kara holds in. Puck off the high glass. Russell, good job on the forecheck. Ledoux on the backhand. Comes up the left wing. Big thundering hit from Jajar Kara. On Michael Marsh, and the puck will go length of the ice. Ontario over the blue line, holding up. Left wing boards is Mike Amadio. Amadio with the puck knocked off his stick. Brady Christopher through center. With speed over the blue line. Christopher got around one man, couldn't get around the second. Ledoux. Poke check by Amadio, and Amadio able to knock it free for Johnny Brodzinski. Brodzinski, dump one deep. Back to touch up Mark Fain. Fain on the backhand around the boards. Held in by the Rain. Behind the net, picked up by Brett Sutter. Sutter right wing half wall. Playing in a 700 professional game tonight. Shot in, blocked down in front. Loose puck gathered. The Condors get it to center. It's a foot race down the right wing. Here's Drake Chase in. On goal is shot up over the top of Campbell. It was off the deflection and out of play. 15:45 to go in the first, and Drake Chase showing what he does best at speed.
Absolutely. I mean, that's the kind of play that you love to see. 25 trying to chase down. He's one of the fastest guys on the ice, and when he can get a hold of that, you never know if he can break himself free and get a scoring opportunity out of it.
15:45 remaining opening period. Nice to have you with us. The three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank on the campus of Bakersfield College at Memorial Stadium. The Rain win the defensive zone faceoff. Here is the aforementioned Michael Marsh. Alternate captain dropped for Zach Leslie. Over the blue line, the puck knocked down in the slot. Condors work it free and back out through center where it's scooped up by the veteran Rob Scuderi. Scuderi's played a number of outdoor games, all at the NHL level, his first AHL one. Bouncing puck all the way back into the Ontario zone. He played in one with the Pittsburgh Penguins as well. Marsh, outlet feed. Through center ice, puck deflected over the blue line where it's picked up by David Musil. Musil knocks it down for Hamilton. Hamilton chips out through center. Hamilton, Beck, and Slepyshev. Beck playing center. Over the blue line, Beck dropping. Slepyshev shot, and Campbell has it gobbled up. 14:59 to go, opening period. We're still looking for the first goal of the Outdoor Classic.
A good opportunity, creative work by Beck coming into the zone. He opted to try to swing a blind pass, drop pass. When you're deep in the offensive zone like that, you can free up a guy like Anton Slepyshev in the circle. You make that play if you can pull it off. He does. Nice shot, just put it right into the crest.
Face off into the left of Jack Campbell. Campbell spent a number of years in the Texas organization, the Dallas Stars organization, I should say. A lot of it being in Cedar Park with the Texas Stars. 14:45 remaining opening period here at the Outdoor Classic at Memorial Stadium. McDermott in the neutral zone out front of the penalty box. It's run into by Kyle Platzer. I think Kyle Platzer likes playing outdoors. He had 2 goals last year in Sacramento against Stockton. Neutral zone, it's Allen.
One of his best games of his rookie campaign.
Puck flipped in right wing corner. Love the natural sound effects down here on the crisp ice at Bakersfield College. On the forecheck, it's Josh Curry. Curry from the Charlottetown, Prince Edward Island. No doubt the Curry family staying up to tune into this one. Would miss their boy playing outdoors in sunny, well, mostly sunny California. Usually. Jarkera picks it up at center ice. Condors have controlled the opening part of this game.
Yeah, they have. It hasn't really equated into shots on goal. The Condors have had the majority of the puck possession.
Over the blue line, Russell shot. Campbell fought that one off, and it kicks to the left-wing corner. To Jarkera in the left-wing corner, dropping it off for Joey LaLegia. LaLegia along the back wall. Skating over the puck was Russell, sent back to the right point, Musil. Musil, left point, Reinhardt. Reinhardt's shot deflected. In front, Kara knocked it down. Kara, back right point. Here's Musil. Wrist shot in. And a stop by Campbell with 13:29 to go in the opening period. And now our first little dust-up post-whistle. But we'll step out, take a break here on KGET. When we come back, Jason Galvin will have you on the other side of this quick timeout. No score. 13:29 to go in the first. This is the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic.
And we're back here at Condorstown, the Outdoor Classic back underway, and a bunch of All-Stars playing in this game today. The AHL just announced their All-Stars as we get back to the game action here. For the Condors, though, Taylor Beck, who just came back down to Condorstown, will appear in the Allentown, Pennsylvania game January 29th and 30th. 9 goals, 21 assists, about 30 points to lead the team for the winger. And for the Rain, defenseman Vincent Laverne and winger Johnny Brzezinski both in that game. Brzezinski actually came off the ice limping a little bit earlier, but Kevin Ryan looks like he's all right now.
Thank you very much, Jason. Jason Galvin down ringside. Ryan Holt, Kevin DeBartle, we're also ringside. Galvin between the benches. Holt and Bartle, the closest we've ever been for a broadcast, no doubt.
It's great. We've almost ended up with a couple of bodies in our lap down here. We almost got hit by a puck. We're getting rained on. It's no big deal, though.
Reminds me of my college basketball announcing days where you were never sure if someone was going to jump out of bounds and right onto the table. Mark Frazier in the neutral zone, hard rim around the glass. What a perspective it is down here, though, calling a game. I love it.
You know, you really kind of, you really get a feel for the game that is lost when you're all the way up in the press box and just how fast these guys are.
Scuderi right out in front of us. Sutter up the left wing. Sutter, the son of LA Kings head coach Darryl Sutter. Top of the right circle. It's Taylor Beck cycling with it. Had a poke check to free. And Mike Amadio will scamper back into the Condor zone. Quickly scooped back up, though, by the big cat, Griffin Reinhardt. Reinhardt back into his own zone. Former Edmonton Oil King Condors out shooting the Ontario Reign 5-1. 12 to go in the opening period here from Memorial Stadium. Reign picking up just a bit here at Memorial Stadium. As we approach the 7 o'clock hour, we were anticipating this. And then after 7:10, this should clear up. We should have cloudy skies the rest of the way. But what a scene here at Memorial Stadium. Big in the neutral zone. McDermott on Beck. Over the blue line, left circle. Shot into the glove of Laurent Bersois. His second save of the evening. It comes with 11:35 to go in the opening period. Ontario comes into tonight's action. Mark, you mentioned 6 straight wins. The Condors certainly enjoy the hoopla, but they know a win tonight gets them back to 500, gets them back moving in the right direction. And they've been tight games against Ontario so far this season.
Yeah, it's been tight games all season long. I was actually talking with Ontario assistant Chris Height last night at the alumni game, and he was remarking about all the overtime games they have played. He says it feels like every single game is 3-2.
11:26 to go in the opening period. Now, Ontario's been overtime 12 times this year. They've ended in overtime 11 times, so they haven't gotten to a shootout much.
That's a remarkable number. I mean, 11 times out of 28 games is about 40% of your games.
And they're not the only ones either. Puck dumped in, Dylan Simpson playing in his third outdoor game. He played in one with the University of North Dakota, jabbed in front, and that one just sent wide into the left-wing corner. Scooped up and a shot whistled wide off the stick of Lowry. It's all the way back to the point. Looked around. That was Mersch. Mersch along the inboards. Centered in front and cleared away by Bakersfield. It'll go length of the ice. 10:46 to go opening period. Condors and Rain are scoreless on this Saturday night in Condorstown. Sam Hare played an outdoor game with the University of Notre Dame. That shot whistled off the outside of the iron. It comes back to the left point. Scuderi turned it over, but then he was able to chop it back down to the Condors end. Jajar Kara able to pick it up out at center ice. What a year for Jajar Kara he's having. 16 points in 22 games for the native of Surrey, British Columbia. Puck in the left wing corner over the stick of Patrick Russell. Scooped up and played up the left wing past Hare. Hare didn't know where that one was coming. And it's played back at the defensive blue line by Mark Frazier. A couple of big hits now as guys start to get comfortable.
And not the first time that a player has lost sight of the puck rimming it around the glass. for Ontario. Remember, they have not skated out here, so they do not know some of the little ins and outs of the boards. One of those things, and a big key of that, dumping it into zone, rattling around the glass, and odd bounces.
We're going to get our first penalty of the evening. It's going to be a roughing decision. And the Condors are going to get a power play here with 9:52 to go in the opening period. Into the box for roughing goes Brett Sutter. And the Condors with a power play. The faceoff into the right of Jack Campbell. But we'll get that when we come back. 9:52 to go in the first. You're watching the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic on KGET.
And welcome back here, Condorstown. Condors getting ready to go on the power play for the first time. Want to show you some video, though, from yesterday real quick here of a family skate that happened here at Condorstown. The rain kind of washed things out all week. Players didn't get a real good chance to actually skate with their families. But they did have an opportunity yesterday after the one practice to bring their families out. It was a lot of fun here and definitely a good experience for all of them. Ryan, Kevin.
Thank you very much, Jason. Jason Galvin down ringside. Ryan Holt and Kevin Partle with you ringside as well. Jason between the benches, and you're right, the Condors on the first power play of the evening. It certainly has been a struggle this year on the special teams for the Condors. 28th in the league at 14.3%, but Ontario, one of the worst penalty kills, at 29th in the league. And excuse the language out on the ice, but we're going to get an offside or an icing call against the Condors.
And you know, just on in regards to the Condors on the special teams, the penalty kills were pretty solid all year long for the Condors. The power play just struggling with inconsistencies. They've had stretches where consecutive games where they've gotten on the board with the power play, but you really need your power play to click for you if you hope to gain any ground in the standings.
I think that was Condors head coach Jerry Fleming you heard and telling the official, no, you're wrong. 9:14 to go in the opening period. I'm just having a blast, folks. This is truly a once-in-a-lifetime memorable experience. Just phenomenal. Condors on the power play, though. Serious business. Here's Taylor Beck down the right wing. He'll rattle one around the kick plate to the left wing half wall. Anton Slepyshev. Slepyshev back to the point. Osterley holds in. He'll send it to the left wing corner. Kara has it. Jajar Kara in the left corner. Kara pass in front. Broken up. Kara gets it back to the right halfboards. Here's Taylor Beck. He was crunched there. Loose puck. Comes up the wall. It's cleared out through center off a couple of bodies the length of the ice. Condors are going to go for a change. A little miscommunication. Popping onto the ice comes Joey Leleshi. He's going to beat his man to the puck. He does so. 8:32 to go opening period. No score. Shots 5-3. 37 seconds remaining on the power play for the Condors. Their first dignity held power play of the night. On the backhand, it's a Griffin Reinhardt. Reinhardt dumping one in. Ryan Hamilton scoops it up. On the backhand, he'll go to work. Sends it up the wall. Kept in by Reinhardt. Down along the end wall. Pass the stick of Patrick Russell to the right corner. Sent back by Scott Allen, but it's picked off and skated to center by Sean Backman. Backman down the left wing. Will send it into the left wing corner. Condors to touch up there. There's 10 seconds remaining on the power play. 7:59. Remaining opening frame. No score from the three-way Chevrolet Condors. Shot outdoor classic presented by Mission Bank. Big heavy hit along the back wall from Scott Allen. Condors get the puck, and he's going to get whistled for that hit. Allen with a heavy hit along the back wall, and that's going to negate, well, the power play just expired, so Allen will go to the box. And now Ontario with their first look on the power play, and they haven't had much going offensively here in the opening 12-plus minutes.
Yeah, the one thing that I have noticed, and I don't know if it's an ice temperature thing or the pucks, but the puck does seem to be bouncing a whole lot, and it doesn't bode well for your special teams where you want to gain the zone and move the puck around cleanly. And that has been one of the early issues here in this game.
7:47 to go opening period. Into the box goes Allen to the power play. Go the rain. There's Michael Hirsch setting up right up in front of the net. That's where you'll see him. His shot deflected wide. Hirsch, one of the top power play guys for this team along with TJ Hensick. 14 power play points this season. 4 goals, 10 assists. Back left point shot in, and a save made by Bressois off the effort from the former Edmonton Oiler, Teddy Purcell.
Yeah, you mentioned Mersch. I mean, just a solid player here for this Ontario club. TJ Hensick, really first chance to talk about him as well. Some big numbers out of him so far this season for Ontario.
Face off into the right of Laurent Bressois. 7:28 remaining, opening a period. Condors and rain are scoreless. Straight away, it's Purcell. Purcell on a seven-game Point streak, left side shot, save for a swat, rebound, kick wide, the Condors get the clearance.
Nice clearance, a very patient, there was that bouncing puck issue I was talking about, wobbling down there, but taking their time, the Condors were waiting for the chance to get the sure clearance, and they do.
1:19 remaining on the power play for Ontario. Condors with the PK unit of Patrick Russell and Yuri Selina, the two Europeans. Puck goes cross ice to the left wing half wall, it's Zach Leslie. Leslie will cycle it in deep, 2-on-2. Loose puck up the boards, it's off the glass, chipped to center, over the blue line, offsides whistled, not whistled down, just waved off. Puck rolls in on Campbell, he'll cover up, and Selina gets a little extra snow shower. 6:43 to go in the first. Just want to send a special thank you to some of our biggest sponsors before this event. Of course, Three-Way Chevrolet, Ted Nicholas and his group, AJ Anton Giovanni and Mission Bank. We wouldn't be anywhere without those two. Dignity Health and CBCC for sponsoring and presenting in the alumni game last night, which was just fantastic. Here at Memorial Stadium to see Wayne Gretzky, Luke Robitaille, and 32 Stanley Cup winners on the ice.
And all three of those groups, not just supporting, you know, this game and the fun that everyone's having out here, but enthusiastically getting behind it. And, you know, both Three-Way and Mission Bank, just all about this event right from the get-go. And huge thanks to them.
The ninth AHL outdoor game in history. Leslie will rim one around. 40 seconds remaining on the first power play of the night for Ontario with Scott Allen in the box for the boarding call. Rain hold in, top of the left circle. It's Leslie straight away. Faking the shot was Laverty. Laverty, an American Hockey League All-Star. Cross ice, Leslie shot off the post, and that one's out. Thank you, referee. That one was off the post. 6:05 to go in the first. Bouncing puck out for a center. Hit the linesman. Carried back in by Ontario. Top of the left circle, a shot. That one kicked out with the right pad. Fibrous swap. It was Backman, and the Condors get the clearance. 4 seconds to go on the power play. 5:48 remaining opening period. Condors at full strength, and the crowd lets them know it. Neutral zone, it's McDermott. McDermott will dump one deep. Picked up on the backhand by Mark Frazier. Frazier spoke all week about how excited he was for this game. As we're going to get the puck played with a high stick with 5:31 to go in the opening period. That will bring us to a media timeout. Don't go anywhere. This is the Three-Way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank. No score. Back with more on KGET.
And we're back here at the Outdoor Classic Memorial Stadium. Took a lot to build this rink, right? A rink inside of a junior college football stadium. Well, Tap of the Mill is coming up here at the first intermission. We'll have video showing you how it was all done, plus a great time lapse by John Hart at the Bakersfield, Californian. Ryan, Kevin?
Thank you very much, Jason. Yeah, I mean, just an incredible project done by Golden State Hockey Rush, Rich Cuban, Mikey Kaplan, and the entire crew. Yeah, just our hats off to them.
Can't say enough about Rich. You know, one thing about Rich, is he's like the eternal optimist. You know, when the rain started coming down today and I'm looking at it and there's puddles on the ice and I look at Rich and he's like, it's fine. It's fine. We'll get it out there. We'll get the sand. We'll do a dry cut. We'll do some squeegees. Ice is going to be fine. Don't worry about it. And as it turns out, all the times he has looked me in the eye and said, the ice is going to be fine. He's been 100% right.
Incredible crowd here at Memorial Stadium for this game. Connors on the faceoff in the attacking zone. We skate five aside. There's 5:17 to go in the opening period. Ryan Holt, the voice you hear. Kevin Bartle, the man to my left. We're the Condors and broadcast team. Nice to have you with us from Memorial Stadium outdoors. Laverty, the captain of the rain, will whip one around into the left wing corner. Puck hopped over a couple of sticks back to center. Taylor Beck looking to get the legs going. Beck played 3 games with the Edmonton Oilers, but back here in Bakersfield, back into his customary role on that top line with the Condors, but playing center here tonight. His first time at center on the day, and we have a loose stanchion, one of the metal plates that keeps the glass intact and in place, has come ajar. So as we just got done mentioning Golden State Hockey Rush and their crew, you're going to get to see them go to work right here with 4:53 to go in the opening period as the crew comes quickly back out onto the ice. They're awesome.
They're running.
Bart, what have you thought of the opening of 15 minutes?
Well, you know, it's been kind of helter-skelter at times. The Condors got off to a pretty good start as far as puck possession in this game. we kind of knew that they were going to come out. I wouldn't be surprised at all to hear the Ontario Reign say that they just wanted to weather an early storm from the Condors. They knew that it would be an emotional game for them. And indeed it was. However, now that we've kind of settled into the game, you see the strengths of the Ontario Reign. They don't surrender very much. They don't give up too much in the way of quality scoring opportunities. The Condors have had one good scrum, scoring type scrum in the immediate front of the net, and that was back in the opening minute and a half of the hockey game. Since then, Bakersfield's had a hard time penetrating the house, if you will. It's been a lot of play on the perimeter in both ends, really.
4:53 to go in the opening period as they fix the stanchion here outdoors. And you have to factor in a lot of different elements. And the rain has stopped now here at Memorial Stadium. We're not anticipating any more weather the rest of the night, which is great. Both the Condors coaching staff, Jerry Fleming, Tony Portford, J.F. Full, Mike Stuthers, and Chris Heita on the Ontario side came together before this game. And Mike Murray and Jason Chamovich from the American Hockey League on site said, well, what do you guys want to do? There's going to be a little weather in the first period, a little light drizzle. Do you want to get this thing going? And both looked at each other and said, game on, and let's get back to it.
Yeah, we're here. Let's play this game.
Condors looking to get back to 500. Ontario looking to extend a six-game winning streak. 4:53 to go in the first. I should note, Ontario, in four of those six wins, went to overtime. Seven of the eight American Hockey League outdoor games all time. That's what they've been. They've been one goal games. You're almost guaranteed a good game at an American Hockey League outdoor classic. We got another tight one here late in the first. The only game which was not close, the Toronto Marlies beat the Hamilton Bulldogs back January 21st of 2012. Ryan Hamilton was a member of the Marlies at that time, his first American Hockey League outdoor game. That game finished 7-2, but a similar setup in Hamilton at Iverwind Stadium, no longer there, the home of the Hamilton Tiger Cats. As to the setup here at Memorial Stadium, you get the grandstands on either side, and you're playing on a football field, which I think is the best venue for an outdoor classic.
No, there's no question. You know, a baseball stadium, and kudos to everybody who's pulled one off in a baseball stadium, but you know, your sight lines are never going to be better than they are, you know, here in a football stadium where, you know, it's a vertical playing surface, obviously, and, you know, great usage of the horseshoe here, too, at Memorial Stadium as well. Of course, it's an old stadium. I mean, just the concept of hosting a sporting event of any kind has really changed over the years. And, you know, honestly lacking in some of the infrastructure that you would expect in a modern-day stadium. So why not take this horseshoe and use it? And the food has been great. The donuts were awesome.
Yep.
You were eating barbecue.
Yes.
Yeah, you had a hot dog.
So, again, Memorial Stadium, 70 years old, 75 years old approaching. I mean, we are so happy to partner up with Bakersfield College for this incredible event. Frank Gifford played here.
Yeah, and don't get me wrong, you know, the age of this stadium, they don't build them like this anymore. It's a beautiful stadium, and even, you know, a couple of months ago when we came down to shoot the first promo down here on the field, you know, the players that came down, it was their first experience seeing the stadium, and they all just loved it and thought, wow, this is going to be great. You got the ring of palm trees on the northeast end. Yeah, you got beautiful grandstands, and yeah, it's just a classic-looking football stadium.
So we're still waiting for this stanchion to be replaced. No problem, because everyone's whipping and nay-naying up in the stands behind us. Can I say that?
I think you can.
We have fireworks going off, too. I'm not sure where those came from. 4:53 to go in the opening period. Ryan Holt, Kevin Bartle here with you. The three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank. No score. 4:53 left. Condors, we're out shooting the rain 5-1. It's now 6-5 Ontario after that power play.
It's been a number of minutes since the Condors last had a shot on goal. I mean, they went through that entire power play and couldn't muster one. But, you know, Ontario, as we mentioned, it's just kind of settled in here. Jason Galvin earlier talking about the goaltending matchup made an excellent point on the goalies in their statistics as well. Very similar.
And just to add another wrinkle to this already wrinkled evening with the weather, they're going to replace the glass and they're going to send the teams to the dressing room. So they're going to go to the dressing room with 4:53 remaining in the opening period and then pick things back up with the end of the first and then the second period. So we're going to have at the end of the first and the second period after we send it to the intermission. So why not? I mean, let's just throw something else into this evening that wasn't planned. But that's what you get when you get an outdoor classic. And this crowd is certainly enjoying themselves here tonight and enjoying this evening in Condorstown. So again, 4:53 remains in the first, but we are going to send it to our first intermission. When we come back, Jason Galvin, Tabitha Mills will have you with a special look at how this rink was built. There's no score, 4:53 to go in the opening period. We'll be back with the first intermission on your home of the Condors, KGET 17.
The Condorstown Outdoor Classic, sponsored by Bakersfield College.
And welcome back here inside Condors Town, inside Memorial Stadium, Bakersfield College. Again, we're going to take our intermission now, even though there was a little over 4 minutes that were left in the period. They're still trying to fix the glass down there next to the Ontario Rain bench that got broken. So they're going to fix that. We're going to take our break and then come back, and we'll finish out the first period and play the second period during this intermission. Look, we are inside of a community college football stadium. How cool is this? The crowd turnout has been really good, even though we had all the elements working against us, the storms all week, the rain today. Still just an amazing turnout by everybody here in town. And we had weeks leading up to this event, right, where fans could come out and skate on the ice and participate and zip line. It was a lot of fun. But to build something like this really takes a lot of people and years of planning. Here's 17 News' Tabitha Mills with a look at how this rink was built.
It starts with more than 1 million pounds of sand, plus enough plywood and plastic to cover it. Then it's 25 miles of piping, 4,000 gallons of heat transfer fluid at 0 degrees, and two 400-ton chillers. Those chillers powered by two generators, enough to power 400 home air conditioning units. Then there's 200 gallons of ice paint on this 200-foot by 85-foot ice rink in Bakersfield College's Memorial Stadium. This time lapse of the process shot over a 10-day period by John Hart at the Bakersfield Californian.
It sounds corny, but we just wanted to do an event that the community would be proud of and that our fans would be proud of, and we hope they enjoy the heck out of it.
And so far, the Condors are definitely enjoying the heck out of it.
It's awesome. Sounds kind of like cliche to say, but it brings you back to being a child up in Canada and skating on the outdoor rink. So I came out here early and I stayed out long because it just brings back good memories.
It took more than a year and more than $1 million, but the Condors Outdoor Classic and Bakersfield's first ever outdoor ice hockey games are here, starting tonight with the NHL Alumni and Celebrity Game, a showdown between Team Gretzky and Team Robitaille. That's right, Wayne Gretzky and Luke Robitaille will be in Bakersfield tonight, along with dozens of other well-known hockey greats.
So the outdoor games on, you know, January 1st and 2nd that you watched on TV, Gretzky's there, he's dropping the first puck, but there's 100,000 people there. I mean, they're not getting up close to the great one. Here you can actually get up close to the great one. $50, you can come down on the field for a fan pass and get it, you know, maybe get a high five from him as he's taking the ice. I mean, that's insane.
Then tomorrow, it's the Condors' turn to hit the ice. They'll play the Ontario Rain.
We're excited. Yeah, we definitely win this one, so we're taking it really serious. But at the same time, we're going to have fun. Realize don't get to do this all the time, so it's going to be a good time.
And that was 17's Tabitha Mills, and I want to show you guys, this was the piece of glass here that went down at the end of the period. It actually delayed us, right? So we got to come back and play the first period. Well, it's back under construction, I guess. They got a new piece in, everything looking good. And take a look at the ice. Zamboni's out here right now, but this ice has really held up well. It is amazing considering all the rain that we've had on and off here all day, and yet still the rink is really in great shape. Everybody doing a great job out here tonight. When we come back, Kevin Bartle and Ryan Holt will be back, and they'll have a full breakdown of most of the first period, right? The first 15 minutes of this game. You're watching the Condorstown Outdoor Classic.
The Condorstown Outdoor Classic, sponsored by Three-Way Chevrolet.
Welcome back to the Three-Way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic, presented by Mission Bank. And maybe it's a good thing that we had that little bit of a glass delay and sent the teams back to the dressing room because the skies have opened up just a bit.
It's just
we're talking.
It's just peaking. It's not open.
This is like a Bakersfield downpour right now.
This is what we're used to.
Yes.
This is no big deal.
No big deal. So, again, no score after, well, 15-plus minutes of play here at the Outdoor Classic. The team sent to the dressing room, so we'll have just over 4 minutes remaining in the opening period. Then the teams will take 30 seconds. They'll switch ends, and they'll start the second period. We see this often in the American Hockey League when it comes to teddy bear tosses. They throw the teddy bears late in the period. Okay, guys, we're going to go to the dressing room.
Right.
We're going to get our break. Then we're going to come back and finish the period and start the second. A little bit of a different scenario out here at Memorial Stadium. Weather coming down, crowd getting restless, but everyone having a great time.
It's fine.
And listen, band is playing. During this entire time, all I've seen is people move to the horseshoe to get themselves probably some mini donuts.
Yeah, if they're smart, they're getting mini donuts. That's all I have to say about that. All right, we got pizza up there. We got barbecue. We got your staples of stadium fare as well, and several beer trucks as well. So, I mean, how can you go wrong here?
You can't go wrong. And so, again, take a look at the first period. Each team had one power play in that period. Neither generated much. Ontario certainly got the momentum a little bit after their power play, but what did you make of the opening 15-plus minutes?
Yeah, I mean, there was a lot early on, a lot of intense play out of the Condors, but, you know, I think overall Bakersfield's been pretty aggressive on the forecheck. That's their game. When they're playing well, they're aggressive, and it creates turnovers, it creates problems. Not too much smooth offensive moves out of either team, and I think just a little feeling out period here in that first period.
Does this kind of wrinkle into the first period? Is this beneficial for either team? Is it against either team?
I don't think so. I mean, everybody's dealing with the same conditions out there, whether the pucks are sitting for them or not, whether they're sitting in the locker room an extra couple minutes or not. So I don't think so.
Condors and the Ontario Reign, no score again. Just over 4 minutes remaining in the opening period when the teams do come back out. Everyone having a blast. The crowd are being entertained by the Centennial High School Band. And we had the Bakersfield College drumline out here earlier today as well to welcome the team to the ice. Hey, just this entire spectacle, Bart, this three-week-long Winterfest, a lot of planning went on. Condors team president Matthew Riley deserves a ton of credit. Condors vice president Justin Fosbender, just what he was able to... I mean, I don't think he ever... Did he ever leave Memorial Stadium? I think Fozzie lived out here at Memorial Stadium. The Edmonton Oilers, our thanks to them, and certainly our great sponsors with Three-Way Chevy and Mission Bank for believing in us really from the get-go, and what an event it's turned into. And yes, certainly, everyone wanted to see a nice clean winter day here in Bakersfield. We haven't gotten that, but that hasn't really ruined anything here tonight.
And hopefully people are still enjoying the spectacle at the moment. And in the end, I don't think a little bit of water falling from the sky is going to ruin people's fun and the opportunity to come be a part of something like this. And you know that it's going well and that people aren't too bothered, but I get the same reaction out of everybody who's come in here this week and has seen this thing for the first time. It's pretty cool.
It's pretty cool.
It's pretty cool just to look at it. That's the reaction.
It's great analysis. It's pretty cool out
it's
here.
It's pretty cool.
It's pretty wet, too, but it's pretty cool, too. So the Condors and the Ontario Reign are currently in the dressing room. Got about another 7 minutes left in the intermission. When we come back, Jason Galvin will hop on with us. We're going to chat more about Winterfest and what he's seen out here at Memorial Stadium over the course of the last week. We'll also mention, of course, the Celebrity and NHL Alumni game last night. That was a load of fun. We'll talk more about that when the night progresses. You're watching the Three-Way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank, live on KGET 17.
The Condorstown Outdoor Classic.
Back to the Three-Way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank. Ryan Holt, Kevin Bartle, Jason Galvin. The skies have now opened up here at Memorial Stadium.
Bartle gave up on his umbrella there.
He did.
And I feel bad because I'm the only one. I can see I got this. You guys can't see me anymore. But
it's all good. I don't care.
I got my Winter Classic too. So
you know, Jason, a brave man likes the feel of nature on his face.
But Bartle, the problem is it's going to mess my makeup up.
Right.
So
yes.
The Condors and the Ontario Reign are scoreless after, 16 minutes of play in the opening period, although I think there's no way we're getting the second period underway if the Reign persists at this rate right here. But they still have the Zam out there cleaning off the water. Scoreless with just over 4 minutes remaining in the opening period. And
Jason, you had a chance to check out the NHL Alumni Celebrity Game last night. A lot of fun here, great night for it, and great to see Wayne Gretzky and Luke Robitaille here at Condorstown.
It was so cool. You know, I grew up down in L.A., so you guys have to forgive me. You're a Kings fan, but it's okay because it helped make hockey in California. That's what I thought was so impressive about this, right? I'm giving them this. That's what I was telling everybody. We're out here. Look at what we've built out here, right? In the middle of California. I was talking to Daryl Evans, right? Longtime Kings great and broadcaster last night after the game, and that's what he said. He's, when I got drafted by the Kings, people think hockey in California, right? Nobody played junior hockey. There was nothing. We built a hockey rink in the middle of a community college football stadium in Bakersfield. So that's what Wayne Gretzky and Luke Robitaille did for hockey on the West Coast. I mean, those two transformed the sport for people like me who grew up and may have otherwise never fell in love with the game of hockey.
And Bartle got to see Danny Gear.
And transformed it for people like us who got to move to California and work for a hockey team and get out of the winter.
Right.
Yeah, so it's great. But yeah.
We're all out here talking about rain and Holtie's over here like... There's 14 feet of snow in my hometown right
nobody
now.
Nobody cares about this back home. We're like, you know, back in New York, it's like, oh, we're getting rain in January? Awesome. Yeah. I don't have to shovel my driveway tomorrow.
And in Bakersfield, we're like, we've had rain for 3 straight weeks. What happened?
Exactly.
I don't know. I'm kind of wet.
Yeah, it is a little wet. Nick James has a really nice look back on last night's game coming up here in the second intermission when we get to that.
So. That's great. It was great to have all those. You know, the one thing I got out of last night was really just the alumni and how much fun they seem to be having. Everybody from Tomas Sandstrom and Bernie Nichols in town. Glenn Anderson and Craig McTavish. Craig McTavish was one of the first guys out on the ice yesterday morning. Yeah. He put the toque on and he got out there and did the morning skate with the boys.
I'm wetting my game notes are
toast. It's the saddest game notes I've ever seen in my
game
life.
We've aborted the game notes. The referees, by the way, are back out, so they think we're playing hockey.
Are we going to start playing Milli Vanilli soon? Let's go to break.
Yeah.
You know, we're going to hang out. It's downpouring at Memorial Stadium, but we're having a lot of fun. This is great. The three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic. No score. 4 minutes left in the first. We'll be back. Don't go anywhere on KGT17.
Back live at the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank. Ryan Holt, Kevin Bartle. We have an umbrella. It is pouring out right now at Memorial Stadium. The teams have come back out onto the ice.
They're on the ice.
But it is downpouring right now at Memorial Stadium here on the campus of Bakersfield College. And again, if you're just new to us, maybe you're watching around the country on AHL Live, our thanks to New Lion for making sure that we have this up on AHLLive.com. I guess the feed is great. The feed's so good. Jason Chamovich up in the cozy confines of the press box all the way up there, chirping me for no tie tonight. That's what we're concerned about right now, the tieless Ryan Holt, not the torrential downpour.
Right. I mean, but you're not wearing a tie. I'm wearing jeans,
and there's
puddles on the ice.
My feet are cold.
No big deal.
This is elements, folks. And again, if you're new to watching games in Condorstown, watching games in Bakersfield, watching games in California, it never rains in Bakersfield. This was supposed to be a La Nina weather pattern, which is the weaker of the two patterns. Of course,
you're not going to get precipitation.
Yeah, which you may be familiar with El Nino, which it didn't rain at all last winter.
This was supposed to happen last winter.
Yeah, except for last winter it rained outdoors. But we are going to have hockey. There's 4:53 left in the first. Let's go live to the rink the torrential downpour. I think we are going to play this. And we'll monitor the situation as we progress. But for now, hockey is back in Bakersfield outdoors. It's full on rain. 4:49 to go in the opening period. Again, Ontario still right to left. The Condors still left to right. Across your TV screens and computer monitors. Down the right wing, on the blue line, Brett Sutter. Sutter, bottom right circle. Through one in front. It is sent out through center by Laurent for a swat. Away comes Taylor back. Back over skated the puck. And I think that one got stuck in a puddle, but we'll play on. I don't think that this thing's going to last much longer here if the puddling continues out on the ice. But we will play on here tonight. Puck bounces over the stick of Mark Fain. Fain up the right wing. There is no chance for cute and fancy plays here in this latter portion of the first.
Listen, everything needs to get on net. Get the puck in the zone. Put it on the goaltender. You never know what's going to happen. This is not going to be a fancy play that gets on the board here.
Condors left wing half wall. It's a Patrick Russell. Battle four out at center ice.
And the one thing that the Condors and the Rain are both going to have to do, they're going to have to move the puck with authority. The Rain is going to slow it down a little bit, even on clean areas of the ice. It's going to slow it down just a bit. Get the puck, know where it's going, fire it.
At least it's not cold. 3:30 to go in the opening period. Harkins back with the right half wall. Curry, Frua towards the front of that. Campbell kicked it out. Stop shot. Frua, puddle of water and a left pad stop made by Jack Campbell. 3:19 to go opening period. Condors hold in left wing corner. It's Allen. That one chip free out through center. Ray moving right to left. The pass across the puddle was held up by Mersch. And they blow it dead for offsides. 3:09 to go in the opening period.
Yeah, correction, the Rain moving straight down on your television screens. Straight down onto your broadcast team.
They'll call you the best color man in the business for nothing, Barts. 3:07 to go opening period. Condors and Rain are scoreless. We're live on AHLLive.com. Wherever you are around the country, I hope you're watching this game indoors. Bucked up to deep, it's Mersch. It's a free AHL weekend on AHL Live as well. Puck gets through Scott Allen. Allen from Edmonton, Alberta. Plays college hockey. Alaska Anchorage. Ontario in the road black jerseys. We have refs falling everywhere now. Ledoux to the blue line.
And he's laughing. He's laughing. He just wiped out. It's funny.
It could be worse. The first Heritage Classic played in Edmonton against Montreal. That game was roughly like minus 50. That's Fahrenheit, not Celsius. Over the blue line, it's Chase. Knocking one forward. Precipitation starting to build up on the glass as well here. 2:19 to go in the opening period. Condors and Rain, scoreless. Puck to the left point, shot. There's a knockdown in front off the stick of Alex Liatuonemi. Over the blue line, here's Greg Chase right half wall. Kicks to the stick, throws it in front, and it was deflected wide by Yuri Selin. This game needs a goal. 48 to go in the first. How fun would that be? It is a torrential downpour right now. Over the blue line, left circle. Puck bounced off the stick of Beck and back the other way. Come the Rain, right half ball shot blocked away by Brissois. That one kicked out and back out through center. Anton Slepyshev, turn it over the blue line. Sutter, right circle, the shot blocked down. Loose puck in the right wing corner, Sutter. Back to the right point, held in by Leslie. Leslie, right half ball shot, fluttered in, stuff shot, they score. Ontario gets the opening goal in the Outdoor Classic. 1:17 to go in the first. Johnny Brodzinski was down on the doorstep as well. And through the raindrops, Ontario has a 1-0 lead.
And nothing fancy at all. A man standing right on the doorstep. Brossois makes the initial save. Can't keep a hold of the rebound. Kicked it right down low and just able to shovel it into the cage. And that's what it's going to take. Just throwing pucks at the net. Attacking the goaltender. Hoping to grind one out.
So in the downpour, Ontario takes a 1-0 lead. 1:16 remaining opening period. Ontario with the 1-0 advantage.
You know, one of the things about the Rain that's probably having the biggest impact on the players is that they're all wearing visors. And the Rain obviously gathers on the visor instead of falling in your eyes, I guess, but potential to cloud some vision as well.
Shot was blocked out in front, deflected away from Sam Hare. Condors back over the blue line. They're going to end this thing soon. This is a torrential, blinding outboard. It's Russell. 36 seconds to go in the opening period. It's 1-0 Ontario. Brodzinski had an assist over the blue line, left circle. Alessia now. His shot kicked out by Campbell. That one from the left circle. Puck knocked down in the right corner. It's Russell for the point. Osterley shot along the ice. Sticked and gloved by Campbell with 19.8 to go in the opening period.
And you definitely, you know, we had a pretty good look. Jordan Osterley giving us a look. Yeah, we're a little wet, Oystee. But he ends up with that wrist shot, and it just kind of cruises along the ice. Definitely going to want to try to lift it up. and because it's going to slow down if it stays along the ice. However, on the other hand, the extra water that is on top of the ice is going to make it more difficult to be able to lift the puck up off and get some air underneath it.
Frazier on the puck knocked off his stick, a big hit from Scott Allen in the neutral zone. That was on Mirisch. There's 10 seconds to go in the opening period. Puck bounces out through center. Knocked down by Mark Frazier and flipped it deep. Campbell played it to the corner. 1 second to go, and that will do it for the opening period of play. The teams aren't going to go anywhere, though. They're going to stay right here after the first period of play. And Kevin Bartle can grab the umbrella. That's great, Bartz. Thank you very much. You know, we are completely toast.
Yeah, we're a little
when
wet.
It comes to everything here. It's a little wet out here.
Yeah, it is. This is three straight Saturdays that we've gotten a significant rainfall here in Bakersfield, and it just doesn't happen. It just doesn't happen. And if you...
Mike Studdins has come off the bench, the Ontario Reign head coach.
Yeah, you're right, he has.
Are the teams looking at one another here?
I'm not sure what is going on, but he did come off the bench to the area that was between. Everybody was kind of gathered together. I'm not sure what was going on.
The goal in the opening period was Brett Sutter playing in his 700th pro game tonight. Sutter from Mike Amadio and Zach Leslie on the goal. It is a downpour right now in Bakersfield.
Yeah. In Bakersfield, if you are into climate sciences, is really just maybe an inch or so above the classification of a desert.
Yeah, we are in the desert.
Yeah, well, I mean, you're right in the ballpark, and Bakersfield averages less than 6 inches of precipitation a year. And gotten half of that since we put a sheet of ice down on the football field. So
Sutter at 18:43 of the opening period, the lone goal of this game. Second period is underway. Puck is down. Game is on, and we're off and running. The eighth goal of the year for Brent Sutter from Amadio and Zach Leslie. So 19:41 to go, second period, and the rain is only intensifying here at Condorstown with 19:41 to go in the second.
You know, as
1-0 Ontario.
As we stand here with electronics on our head in the rain,
and that was coming down sideways.
I was just thinking, if only the wind could pick up. If only the wind could pick up and maybe the temperature could drop 5 to 10 degrees, that'd be great. And what do you know? It delivers.
Mark Frazier back to his own end. Osterley, the pass broken up. Backman held in. Right wing circle. Rashad, he scores. Just an auger from the bottom of the right circle. Rashad over the top of the glove. Handler up for a swap. Time of the goal, 34 seconds into the second period. It's 2-0 Ontario.
That's a heck of a shot right there in these conditions to be able to pick the corner like that. Brossois had the angle on it, goes down to try to protect as much as he can, and with the water that's gathering, smart play as well to get down. But he finds the top shelf right up under the crossbar over Brossois' shoulder, and it's a 2-0 lead.
So 2-0 Ontario, Sutter with the goal in the first, and now Justin Auger, his seventh from the right wing circle. Pucked up in behind Jack Campbell. Campbell on his net to play it. Through the water, back to the blue line. There is significant water on the ice. I'm not sure how this game is still going on, but we're still playing it. It's 2-0 Ontario. 19:13 to go, second period.
You have to imagine that people in the know, not us, of course. We're just standing down here in the glass.
We're just a couple of guys who
we're probably watching.
Thought it was a great idea to stand outdoors.
And people, anyways,
puck went out of play, and I think we're going to have a delay of game call against Ontario.
I think we need to.
Right off the faceoff.
What I was going to say was people probably paying attention to the radar, or else it would have been very easy just to step aside for 15, 20 minutes and wait for this to pass. I got to imagine as I stand here, not on my phone, looking at the weather radar, that there doesn't appear to be an immediacy to the lifting of this. But regardless, the rain fans, by the way, making their presence known as their team leads 2-0.
So a Dignity Health Mercy Memorial Hospital's power play for the Condors. 19:09 to go second period. They could use one here. Well, I'm not sure what you draw up in a downpour. Rain has lightened up. Puck goes all the way down into the Bakersfield zone. They're moving right to left. Slepyshev, Kara, Beck, Osterling. Neutral zone, it's Kara. Jajar Kara sprinting down the left wing. Gates of blue line. To the right wing half ball. Slepyshev shot, and that one fought off by Campbell, up and out of play. 18:40 to go in the second, 1:31 remaining on the power play. Let's go, Condors, the chant from this crowd, which has thinned a bit since the rain has started, but everyone was looped up early here, Barnes. Tailgating began at 7:00 yesterday morning, and people have been treated to a fun weekend, certainly dampened by the rain just a bit. Puck covered up by Campbell as he sprinted all the way out and did a snow angel in the pond in the slot. I'm not sure I could call that a snow angel. A water angel? Lietti Niemi is the green in the box with 1:27 remaining on the power play. Condors win the faceoff. Shot from the point, hit a leg. It's pond hockey here in Condorstown right now at the Outdoor Classic.
Actually kind of makes it easier to see the puck out there as it's creating a wake.
There's Taylor Beck with speed over the blue line, right half wall. Beck throws it in front, deflected wide off the outside of the net. Scooped up in the left wing corner. There's Slepyshev with Kara, battling below the goal line. Force free shot from Slepyshev, blocked out. The rain trying to come shorthanded, they'll just dump it deep. Past Osterley, length to the ice. I should note the Condors have their second period jerseys on.
Yes,
17:57 to go in the second. So they still have worn two different jerseys tonight. These are the second period jerseys. Now Hamilton over the blue line. He'll carry right wing half wall. 37 seconds remaining on the power play. Griffin Reinhart back in his own end. Gonna need a new suit. Lushy on the back end. Carries up the right wing. A lot wiser than me. It's 2-0 Ontario. Goals from Brett Sutter and Justin Auger here tonight in the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank. 17:20 remaining second period. 10 to go on the power play. LaLegia up the left wing, Reinhart. Reinhart through center ice. That puck poke check free. All the way back into the Condors end. LaLegia up the left wing, Reinhart. Reinhart turning it over. Mersch in front of the doorstep. Sutter shooting at a big stop made by Bressois. Redirect effort, another save from Bressois. And the Condors will pick it up back behind their own net. Couple of big stops from LB.
Yeah, and great work by him to keep an eye on the man in front and one eye on the puck.
Over the blue line, losing an edge and going right into the net as Campbell jumped over. And I have a feeling that that potentially could delay things just a bit. Campbell jumped up over the top. We'll see if that action brings anything. 16:45 to go, second period. Campbell, good ups that time, getting over the fallen Condor, but I think the rain's letting up just a bit.
No doubts over the last couple of minutes. It's pretty much mellowed out to a little bit of a mist. And the breeze continues to kick, which may actually help dry things out a little bit out here. You know, in retrospect, Ryan, looking pretty ingenious with a new jersey every period. Nobody's going to have to come out next period with a wet jersey on.
It's great.
Just saying.
It's a great idea.
Get a fresh jersey every period, and you're nice and clean and dry.
16:30 to go, second period. Pucked off deep. It's Dylan Simpson on the backhand. Simpson rims one around to the right wing half boards, Christopher. Michael Latta came down the wall. Simpson up the left wing. Brady Christopher with an outlet feed. Bouncing puck over the red line through a puddle. Off a stick and picked up by Ontario. On the backhand in their own end with Sam Hare. Hare at the attacking blue line. That puck knocked off his stick. Greg Chase goes in on the forecheck. Greg Chase recently celebrating birthday number 22. New Year's baby. David Musil. Outlet pass. Neutral zone. Over the blue line. Come the Condors, but they're offsides. 15:47 to go in the second period. I think we're commercial free the rest of the second period. With 15:47 to go in the second. Ontario with a 2-0 lead. Goals are from Sutter and Auger. Sutter late in the first, Auger early in the second. .15:43 to go, second period. Outlet pass tipped in to the Ontario zone. Rob Scuderi, the veteran, back to pick it up. Scuderi acquired by the LA Kings organizations last year. Pass in front, deflected up by Karen, just over the cage with Russell. Here's Karen in the right-way corner, threw one in front, and Lalonde had to go off his stick. Ontario with speed back to the center. They'll dump one in deep. Mark Frazier back with it. Frazier up the right-wing side. Thrown high up in the air, Lalegia. And it knocked away from him. Auger, second goal scorer of the evening. Walking in, same shot, save made for a swap. Rebound kicked wide. Lalegia at the defensive blue line. Karen, cross ice, Russell. Patrick Russell, wrist shot. And that one blocked it off a leg. 14:57 to go, second period. The rain has completely stopped now. Puck in the neutral zone. Flipped in behind for a swap. On the backhand feint. Reinhardt to pick it back up. Reinhardt up the left wing. It's Hamilton. Ryan Hamilton at the defensive blue line. Now comes through center. Had the puck poke checked off. And stick by Brodzinski, the all-star. Brodzinski carries to the left wing corner. Reinhardt running to a lot of back wall by the goal scorer in the first period, Brett Sutter. Set back to the left point. McDermott holds in. McDermott shot through traffic. Knocked down. It's loose in the high slot. Bouncing puck picked up, Brodzinski shot. Nobody saw where it went. It went right into the glove of Brassois, and he hangs on. 14:19 to go in the second.
I give these players a lot of credit. It's definitely not ideal conditions on the ice. There still is some standing water. Extra concentration, and here down at ice level, we get a pretty good look at that. Guys giving one extra look to their stick, making sure the puck is still on it. But, you know, playing through these type of conditions, I give them a lot of credit. I think they're faring quite well.
14:18 to go here in a period number two.
Still plenty of time here for the Condors.
Shot in, Brassois save. Loose puck get kicked wide by TJ Hedsick. Condors clear it late to the ice. Plattrick goes in on the forecheck. Comes back to the center. Now that the rain has stopped, chance of maybe some normalcy to this game. As normal as you can get it. And an icing call against Ontario will bring the faceoff back down in the REIGN zone. 13:50 to go.
You haven't called TJ Hensick's name a whole lot here in this game, and this Rain team has some big bodies on it. TJ Hensick is not one of them, but he does have the biggest numbers on the squad, second on the team in goals, leads the team in assists and points this season, nearly a point per game clip for him, 26-28, and he stays out of the box.
13:43 to go in the second. Bonders on the forecheck. Left wing half wall. Puck goes bouncing up the near side wall. And we're going to get a cross-checking call against Kyle Platzer. 13:32 to go, second period.
Yeah, and Platzer just a little bit too much that time on the forecheck. After he was down around the cage, tried the wraparound, tried to knock the rebound towards the goaltender. A little over-exuberant out of Platzer. He'll put the rain on the power play. This is not the type of conditions on the ice to really, you know, it definitely doesn't benefit a team setting up in their normal play on the power play. Be interesting to see how Ontario handles it.
13:30 to go, second period. So Ontario, on their second power play of the night, they had one unsuccessful back in the opening period, which feels like forever ago. Pucked up deep. Out of his net to play it is Jack Campbell. Up the left wing, Brodzinski. On the man advantage, Rashad Glove Sabre swap. He hangs on.
You know, of all the players on the ice, that you have to kind of feel for playing a little bit wet. The goalies are number one. I mean, even on under normal conditions, it's been said that a goaltender can lose up to 10 pounds every game just from playing under the weight of their gear and all the normal sweat that they have. But when it's raining on your goaltender, it makes his equipment that much heavier. All that much more important that the Condors get some traffic in and get some pucks in on Jack Campbell.
12:45 to go in the second period. Neutral zone. Nice job by Josh Curry. You hear Kerr sit on the ice. No secret, that's his thing. 12:34 to go. Puck tucked in. Pass Mark Frazier, and we're going to get an icing call.
Yeah, and that's Curry, a nice play out at center ice as well. Lost control of the puck, but forced his man into a premature dump into the offensive zone. He had not yet gained the red line, so Curry, shift over. Job well done on the PK.
Condors trail the rate 2-0 in the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Class. 12:28 to go, second period. The rain has subsided, but Ontario in the monsoon. At least Bakersfield's edition with a 2-0 lead. Right half wall, Celine is shot wide of the blocker side of Jack Campbell. 12:10 to go, second period. 37 seconds remaining on the rain power play. It's thrown in on Bressois, and he will cover it. 12:05 to go, second period. Faceoff will come to the left of Laurent Bressois. Latta, Amadio, Sutter Ledoux, and McDermott, who had the overtime game winner against the Condors a week ago. Right point, it's Ledoux holding wrist shot off the leg of David Musil, who took that one around the shin pad. Puck tied up in the right way corner. Condors still have 23 seconds remaining on the rain power play. Loose puck, Musil on the backhand up the right wing wall. Hamilton knocked it out through center ice. 11:40 remaining, second period. Over the blue line, it's Amadio. He'll dump it deep. Condors a touch up in the corner with Hamilton. Condors back to full strength. Out of the box comes Platzer. Jajar Kara with it back behind his own net. Five-a-side hockey. 11:23 left in the second. Outlet feed, neutral zone. It's Simpson. Simpson will just carry it over the blue line. Top of the right circle. Wrist shot. That one wide of the net. Puck comes to the left wing corner on the forecheck. Goes Taylor back. Back right wing. Half ball wrist shot. And Campbell read it well. He'll potch that one down with 11:07 to go in the second. You're listening and watching the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank on KGET and AHLLive.com.
A really good penalty kill out of the Condors. Through all the conditions, they made smart plays. They got traffic in front of puck carriers, made things difficult for the rain.
11 minutes straight up left in the sec. Bouncing puck to center. Picked up and dumped in by Mark Fain, right in on Jack Campbell. That's not a bad decision. Now Beck turns one off the outside of the net. Taylor Beck, bottom of the left circle, holding on the backhand. Puck knocked free. Top of the left dot, it's LaLegia. LaLegia holding into the left wing corner on the backhand. A slap a shift and off his stick. And away come the rain out through center. Over the red line, dumping one deep. The RAIN rain subsiding.
And the radar looks clear the rest of the way, by the way. That's the word I have.
It looked clear earlier, too. Yes. No weatherman, but I stayed at the Holiday Inn Express last night. Here's LaLegia on the backhand. Knocked away by Crescenzi. Threw one back through the slot. It comes all the way back to the point. Crescenzi right point. Held in by Zach Leslie. Always like seeing, of course, I'm not sure if it's needed tonight, but always enjoy seeing the eye black to the outdoor games.
Yeah.
Under 10 to go, second period. Ontario with a 2-0 lead. Sutter and Auger with the goals tonight. Puck set deep, Frazier. Versus directions, outlet feed Osterley. Shots in this game are, if I can read the card correctly, 18-10, 18-16. 18-16 Condors.
of the water that is still on the ice in significant quantities. Most of it looks like the trouble areas are in the neutral zone.
Glad you can see that. 9:30 to go, second period.
Well, I'm half making up what I'm talking about anyways.
Certainly a once-in-a-lifetime experience, no doubt. Backhand shot off the outside of the net. Loose puck gathered. Condors trying to skate to center. Great chase with his head down. He's making sure he held the puck. Now Christopher right circle. Christopher hauled down to the ice. He's going to draw a penalty. And a power play upcoming for the guys in cream with 9:06 to go in the second period. Looks like a holding call upcoming against Ontario.
Yes, indeed. Bring Christopher. Nice work driving down the slot. Draws the penalty immediately. Just the head to the bench. Let that power play unit come out. The Condors really could use one here. We're past the halfway point of this hockey game, and Bakersfield really needs to get on the board at this point. If anything, just to loosen themselves up a little bit. Get on the board, make this a one-goal game, put the pressure, keep the pressure in on this Ontario squad. It's been a much better second period than the first period ended for the Condors. Let's see what they can do with it.
9:05 to go, second period. Ontario with a 2-0 lead, but a big dignity held power play for the Condors here with Michael Mersch in the box for the next minute 50. 8:54 remaining, second period. Bakersfield through center. Beck was upended at the attacking blue line. Bouncing puck. Beck able to swizzle one back. He'll send it to the right wing corner on the forecheck. Josh Kurt. Puck whipped around to the half boards off Slepyshev. And a set length to the ice. Out of his net to play it, it's Leroy for a swap. He'll drop for Jordan Osterley. Osterley with a man on. 8:30 to go, second period. 1:22 remaining on the second power play of the night for Bakersfield. Beck, hard rim around the dashers. Left wing half-boards, Kara to the point. Held in there by Beck along the end boards, Kara. Back through the slot, the pass picked off. And cleared for the neutral zone. LaLegia in a foot race. They go back into the defensive end. LaLegia up the left wing for Scott Allen. Allen for the neutral zone. His pass broken up. Sent back to the Condor zone. Purcell will get a change. Condors trail a 2-0 with under 8 to go in the second. The rain subsiding. And Griffin Reinhart with the puck. Gains the red line. Hard rim. Campbell dropping. Sent back out to the defensive blue. LaLegia held in. His shot blocked down. Left circle, Condors hold in, Reinhart to the right circle. Wrist shot, that one wide of the net. It's rimmed all the way around, and we'll get length to the ice.
Everything's got to get on net right now for the Condors. They can't afford to miss opportunities like that. It's so hard to get that puck to settle down, to move it crisply and get set up in the offensive zone. To have to go back and start all over again in your own end hurts.
7:14 to go, second period. Condors. Trail array 2-0, and the power play is over. Michael Mersch steps out of the box. Outlet pass up the left wing. Over the blue line comes Allen. Allen high sliding on a bended shot, saved Campbell, and Hamilton jabs the rebound wide. Behind the net, Connor scooping up, and the puck goes off the outside of the net and then is covered up by Campbell, and he hangs on with 6:49 to go in the second. You're watching the three-way Chevrolet Connor's Town Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank. KGET. 6:49 remaining, second period. Ryan Holt and Kevin Barnell here with you this evening. We're still wet.
but trying out.
Rain has subsided.
Yeah, and really the intermission will come in a good time here for the rink crew. They can get out there, give it a dry cut, get some of the water off the ice, let it dry up. I'm actually more concerned right now about my dogs at home than I am the ice condition after we'll get an intermission in.
Right point, Ledoux, shot glove save, Brassois, who saw that one through traffic. 6:34 remaining in the second. It's 2-0 Ontario. Live from the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown after Classic presented by Mission Bank. 2-0 rain, goals from Auger in the second, and Sutter back in the first.
This rain squad, they have a really good team here, and Campbell with the numbers that he's put up this season, at least win-loss wise, it's kind of like, you know, new name, same story for this Ontario Reign squad. And of course, their goaltender from last year in Los Angeles, putting up good numbers for the Kings.
Condors hold in. The pass through the slot. That one came from LeLegier. Right half wall, Kara. Side of the net. Bouncing puck. Jabbed at by Kara again. Threw a couple of puddles. Threw a wake. And back to the top of the right circle. Puck flipping around. Bounces. The Ontario blue line over the stick of Auger. Auger comes together with Simpson. Chipped it past him. Auger bottom of the right dot. Cuts to the front of that. Good, strong, heavy play from Dylan. Simpson coming back to take out Justin Auger, heading to the front of the net. Now Musil up the wall. We watch this one right out in front of us. Condors in the crease. With the orange shoulders, Ontario and the All Blacks. Great jersey matchup as well. Puck clear length of the ice. Nice deflection from LeLegier. 5:40 to go second period. 2-0 Rain. Over the blue line, it's Brodzinski. Crunched into the boards by Mark Frazier. Right circle, Amadio shot. Save, Brassois. Rebound, kicks through the crease. And the Condors pick it up. Here's Slepyshev. Long outlet pass. Looking for Beck. It's over the blue line. Just missed connection that time with Taylor Beck. Trying to creep in down the left wing. Starting to see both teams starting to make a couple extra plays now. Things dry out over the blue line. Amadio, right circle. Shot wide. Back to the left point. Held in by the Rain with Rob Scuderi. Shot from the bottom of the right circle. Kicked out by Brassois. Had trouble getting back up. Just because of the moisture. Osterley over the blue line. Top of the left circle. Wrist shot. Knocked down by Campbell. Left half wall. Condors keep it alive. Beck cross ice. Right point shot. Deflected in front of the stop by Campbell. And the rebound poke checked away from Reinhardt. Out through center. It's a one-on-one. Against the Mark Fain. Teddy Purcell. Former teammates. And Fain able to knock that one away. Out through center. And then it's dumped in deep.
Former teammates indeed last year up in Edmonton. Purcell now part of the Kings organization. Fain here in Bakersfield.
Reinhardt, outlet pass, neutral zone. Scott Allen, top of the left circle. Allen will dump one deep. Into the left wing corner with 4:18 to go in the second period. Rain with a 2-0 lead. Goals from Sutter and Auger tonight. Platzer in his own end. Third outdoor game for Kyle Platzer. He played at one of Detroit at Comerica Park. The member of the London Knights. That's an offside against Bakersfield. 3:59 to go second period. And at least we get one solid period of uninterrupted hockey, as it should be, outdoors. You just kind of have to say what if, but at some point you just trudge through it.
Yeah, and you know, it is a big what if, and not that people aren't enjoying themselves and enjoying the spectacle of this night, but what if indeed.
Cut. 3:48 to go in the second. If you're wondering where you can catch all post-game highlights and everything and reaction from the dressing room, you can check out our YouTube channel, Condors.tv. Have a lot of cool stuff up there as well. Puck flipped over the head of Dylan Simpson. Came right into our living room.
There's some great content up there already. Some stuff put together by the Oilers TV crew. A huge shout out to them. Making the visit down here to Condorstown, and always have a good time with those guys. They do great work and put up some great videos, and happy to share those with the Condorstown faithful.
3:10 to go second period. 2-0 Ontario. Ninth AHL outdoor game. Latta shot wide, blocker side, Brassois. To the left wing half-boards. Passing front, Latta off a skate, and it's picked up by Kara. Nice defensive play from Kara. He went through a car wash. That was dumped in over the blue line. It's like those spindles. Is that what they're called? With the looks like the big giant toothbrush on the stick when you go through, and it just kind of goes over the top of your car. That's kind of what Jujar Carey just went through. Shot in, save, Brassois. Big stop at the top of the crease from LB. Back to the left point. Shot knocked in off the leg by Russell. And Russell out through center. It's Osterley. Osterley pass broken up on the back check by Sean Back. 2:20 to go second period. Shots are 20-19. Love to see the fancy stats on this one tonight. How good's the Corsi and Fenwick on the zone entries and exits?
Probably not good.
Top of the left circle, it's Slepyshev. Back into the Bakersfield zone, Griffin Reinhardt. On the backhand, play for Mark Fain, reversing directions. Reinhardt, outlet pass, through the neutral zone, tipped in by Slepyshev. Ryan Hamilton always remarks, these are the memories that you have throughout the course of a professional career.
I remember the time that he was playing a game and it was raining on him.
1:30 to go in the second. Pucked up into the Bakersfield zone. Picked up by Slepyshev. Native of Penza, Russia. It's on Slepyshev back at Condorstown. D to D, Griffin Reinhardt.
You know
the left wing.
You know where it doesn't rain in January?
Penza, Russia. Slepyshev had a great start to his second time in Bakersfield. 10 points in 8 games. Whistle blown dead. And offsides will be the decision with 1 minute remaining in the second period.
You know, just on Slepyshev as he's come down from Edmonton, you know, there is a difference in the speed of the game and the way guys process the game and what's happening in front of them. And you could see that Slepyshev at times has looked like a completely different player here with the Condors than we saw last year. And, you know, it's been great. He appears to be utilizing all of his assets well here. And I imagine that he was doing much of the same in training camp in Edmonton. That's what earned him an opportunity to stick around a little bit longer.
46 seconds remaining in the second period. Condors trailer 2-0. We'll have, we think, an interview with Ryan Hamilton at the end of the period's conclusion. Second frame. Puck in the neutral zone. And offsides against Bakersfield with 19.4 remaining in the second.
Important 2 points here for the Condors, and it's going to be an important 20 minutes up on the board for the third period here for the Condors. This is one of those games where middle of the season, big matchup against the red-hot team at the top of your division. The Condors need to start gaining some ground. I mean, that's the bottom line right now. Bakersfield has weathered a lot of early storms here this season as far as dealing with roster changes and
how many
whatnot,
weather puns are you going to come up with tonight?
But they need to start gaining some points, and this would be a great time to start.
It's the end of the second period. Jason Galvin will have an interview with Ryan Hamilton upcoming. The Condors and the Ontario Reign head to the dressing rooms with Ontario in front by a 2-0 score line. Bartz, your thoughts on the period plus that we saw here at the Outdoor Classic in the second?
I can honestly say it was one of the strangest periods of hockey I've ever witnessed.
Condors and the Reign head to the dressing rooms. Condors with a 2-0 deficit, looking to dig out of that here in the third and final period of regulation. Goals in that sequence, back late in the first, Brett Sutter, and then in the second, Justin Auger to make it a 2-0 lead for Ontario after 40 minutes of play. Reign and Condors making their way back down the walkway. Looking to have an interview with Condors captain Ryan Hamilton. Jason Galvin has him ringside.
And we're here with Condors captain Ryan Hamilton. 2-0 Ontario after two periods here. Ryan, how would you assess the game so far?
Well, this is definitely a first. I don't think both teams have ever played in conditions like this, but you know, thanks for all the fans coming up. It's a great atmosphere, and you know, in saying that, both teams are playing out there, and we're down two, and we got to battle back here.
What do you think you guys need to do in the third period to come back?
Well, you know, obviously the ice conditions are soaking wet. You can't really skate or pass the puck, so it's got to be simple hockey. Get pucks in deep, put pucks to the net, and bang away. And you know, if you do that, you're going to get the goals, I think.
All right, Ryan, good luck. Thanks.
Thank you.
All right, Ryan Hamilton, captain here with the Bakersfield Condors. 2-0 after two. You heard it, Ryan. Kevin, got to play simple hockey, right? That's all you can do.
Yeah, at least the weather has lightened up here in Condorstown. The weather lightening up. which means that hopefully the third period will be played without much obstruction, no rain, get the good ice conditions, and we're having Chuck-a-Puck with Freeway Chevrolet. Hold on. Let's see if I can.
Why do you think I picked that up? I was going to throw it.
Oh, I came up short.
That was lousy.
That was a bad throw.
That was lousy.
All right, when we come back, we'll have the second intermission report. Here from the Outdoor Classic, it's 2-0 Ontario. The rain has stopped, but the rain have a 2-0 lead. Back with more from Memorial Stadium after these a quick time out.
And welcome back. Look at that. Just like that, I got a Chuck-a-Puck. This one wasn't the winner. Three-way Chevrolet Chuck-a-Puck contest here. Condorstown Outdoor Classic inside BC Memorial Stadium. It's 2-0 Ontario after two periods. And Chuck-a-Puck's fun. Winterfest was fun. But I tell you, outside of this game, maybe the best event they've had so far, last night here, Friday night event at Bakersfield College Memorial Stadium, the Condors Alumni Celebrity Game. So many greats from the Edmonton Oilers, Los Angeles Kings, the world of entertainment and hockey in general. Here's 17 Sports Director Nick James with a look at the event.
A plethora of people, nearly 8,000 fans of all ages, made it out to the Alumni Celebrity Game on Friday night to watch a competitive hockey matchup that Team Luke Robitaille won 9-8 over the great one, Wayne Gretzky.
People are going to love it. The ice is great, and it's a great facility. The guys have done a really good job. I mean, sometimes it's hard to come up with the ice, but it's better than inside some of the buildings. So I think fans are going to be real happy with this game.
This crazy girl right here told me it was going to be fun. And it's cold, but it's fun. We're having a good time here with family and friends.
Team Gretzky, go!
We planned it a little while ago. We have a whole group. It was mainly my boys that got things going for us. We went to one in LA a couple of years ago, so it was fun.
Once again,
my brother-in-law had a baby, so he said, "Hey, here's my tickets. I brought my grandpa right here, so we're just here to have a good time."
All right.
Oh, it's awesome. Awesome. Never seen an outdoor game before, so it's
Mike,
pretty cool.
I told you.
It's awesome. It's so awesome. We love him.
The great one did not play because he had a growing injury, but had great things to say about Bakersfield.
The Oilers have done a great job at putting a wonderful organization together here in Bakersfield. And Bakersfield has been a really good minor league hockey town. And this is going to be a fun night. I think everybody's going to have a good time.
Outdoor shebang is huge. Honestly, Gretzky, Robitaille, it's such a big deal to have such great hockey in this city no matter what. And then you have these greats that come and visit because Bakersfield is so hockey friendly. We're a big hockey family. It's just, it's a wonderful thing for Bakersfield.
There was some sipping, there was some yelling and cheering, and just a great atmosphere to be a part of. For 17 Sports, I'm Nick James.
And Dan, thanks so much, Nick. Here, check this out. We went from a Chuck-a-Puck to a Chuck-a-Real-Puck, right? That's our photographer, Octavio, throwing it to me. Look at this here. Let's see if we can get a zoom in. That there is your official game puck of the American Hockey League and the Bakersfield Condors and the Condorstown Outdoor Classic. Look at this. Meadows Field Airport on the back. I guess is that because the pucks fly, literally, here, huh? Right? That thing flew over the glass. I tell you what, me and down here, that's the one thing you got to watch out for. These in the head would not be good at all. Hey, it's 2-0. Condors trailing to Ontario here after two. Still one more period to go, and even better, the skies are dry for the time being. That ice still holding up pretty well. We'll check in on how that's going here and be back with Ryan Holt and Kevin Bartle in a recap of the sloppy second period here from Condors down. This is the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic here on KGT TV 17.
The Condorstown Outdoor Classic, sponsored by Bakersfield College.
Welcome back to the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank. We're in the second intermission report here outdoors. Ontario with a 2-0 lead over the Condors after 40 minutes of play. We've resorted to the phones because all technology is pretty much a wash, literally.
Paper's not even technology, but it was once, right? But my paper's toast.
Goals tonight, Brent Sutter at 18:43 from Zach Leslie and Mike Amadio, and then Justin Auger at 34 seconds of the second. That was unassisted. The second period, for the most part, was played, well, in a monsoon, a Bakersfield style. Puddles everywhere on the ice. They got through the second. We're clear the rest of the night, so we're going to have a good third period, a clean third period. And Jason, hopefully a third period where the Condors get back to doing what they were doing back in the opening period when they were playing well early on in that first period.
The Condors had some momentum early on. They were getting opportunities. You know, they had a power play there. They couldn't capitalize. And Laurent Brossoit looked great until we took the break. You almost wonder, you know, like Ryan Hamilton said, nobody has played in this. Even back in, you know, their childhood, nobody played in downpours. They played in snow, but not a downpour. So you wonder how much that affected things. The puck's not bouncing the way it normally would. You can't see what's going on, especially with the goalie mask on and the rain dripping down. I mean, even when Ryan came off the ice there, he had water dripping off his visor, and it stopped raining 10 minutes ago.
The good news for the Condors, they're wearing three different jerseys tonight. Yeah. So the third period, fresh jersey. They'll have the Oil Drop logo. We'll step out, take a break. More of the second intermission report when we come back from the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank.
The Condorstown Outdoor Classic, sponsored by Three-Way Chevrolet.
Welcome back to the Three-Way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank. Ryan Holt with Kevin Bartle. 2-0 Ontario after two periods of play. We're getting set for the third period. No rain. Ontario's getting set to come back out, but no R-A-I-N rain. And during the intermission, Kevin Bartle found himself some food.
Yeah. Well, it wasn't hard. I went to the VIP section. The smartest people in this building, by the way.
They have a tent.
They're in the VIP section.
What do you have here?
I got some I have some pulled pork from Salty's Barbecue, and I even brought two rolls, one for me, one for you.
That's
so
great.
That we can have a little snack before the third
I appreciate
period
that, Kevin.
I'm looking out for you.
Kevin, I appreciate that. That's why he's the best color man in the business. We have food, grab a beverage, and you grab a snack. We get the third period when we come back after a quick 30-second timeout. Third period next. Condors trail the rain 2-0 at the three-way Chevrolet. Condors Town Outdoor Classic, presented by Mission Bank. We're having fun outdoors. We're making pulled pork sandwiches. We're back for the third period. Ryan Holt, Kevin Bartle, back here live at the Outdoor Classic.
Listen, I've been told.
What have you been told?
I've been told it's unprofessional to eat while you're on the air. And no. You know what? I couldn't care less. If this is what I do.
If this is wrong, I don't want to be right. Puck is down. Game is on. We're back off and running for the third period. Nice to have you with us on the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic. I put down my pulled pork sandwich. Get ready for some action. 19:40 to go, third period. Condors left to right. Now wearing the Oil Drop as their crest.
Nice and dry jerseys for the third period. This is genius. It couldn't have worked out better.
Bouncing puck, neutrals up. Ice is fantastic now. No rain. Condors trail 2-0. They have a comeback in them outdoors. Karras shot blocked out. Bounces to the side of the net. Karras kicked it free to the right way. Corner Lalegia. Joey Lalegia up the wall. Mark Fain, right point shot. Tempted front over the top of the cage by Jajar Karras. There's a point shot from Fain. The Oil Drop as the crest of the Condors secondary logo. That shot goes up and out of play.
So I talked to some members of the rink crew during the intermission. Just asked them what their tactic was when they got out there with the Zambonis. They mainly just did two dry cuts, two Zambonis out there doing a dry cut, very minimal usage of water on the ice. There already was some water, but going through a dry cut, and for those of you who don't know, what the Zamboni normally does is two things. It cuts the top layer off the ice and lays a thin layer of hot water onto the ice to help seal some grooves and everything like that. A dry cut is one that does not involve water, just the gears.
Here's Hamilton, left circle, backhand, and a left pad stop made by Campbell. That was the best chance the Condors have had in a while. Now a point shot, he scores!
Parks made for the right point. The Condors are within one with 18:39 to go in the third.
I can honestly say in my broadcast career, I've never had a better view of a goal that's been scored than the one that we just had. Mark Bain was right in front of us on the glass, let a wrist shot go. Tons of traffic in front of Campbell. He had no prayer on that one. It went five-ski, and the Condors were on the board.
Mark Bain, his first goal back in Condors style. The point shot beat everybody. And yeah, what a view.
And most importantly, it comes in the early minutes of this third period. It gives them plenty of time to complete their comeback. Just a minute and a half in.
Mark Bain, his first of the year. Kempe, out through center, on the right wing. The pass broken up. Condors feeling it now. Fresh out of ice. 18-16 to go in the third. Fresh jerseys. The good sheet. No rain. And Mark Fain has brought the Condors to within one.
Hamilton and Beck picking up the assists on that one. You go right to the top of the scoring list here for the Condors, and the Big Cuns get him on the board.
Beck, 31 points this year. He's in the top 10 in the American Hockey League in scoring. He was the top point getter in the AHL when he left for the NHL a couple of weeks ago. Played just now his 20th game with the Condors. Here's Christopher down the right wing on the backhand all the way around. What an event and evening this has turned into. That goal is brought the decimal level up and pick. Bouncing puck in on Bressois. He'll sprawl the cover with 17:34 to go in the third. Fain from Hamilton and Beck from the right point to bring the Condors to within 1-2-1. Talked with Jason Chamovich, AHL PR head, as he came down during the period just to check on us, make sure we were doing all right. Yes, we have.
Very nice of him.
Yeah, just a nice gesture from him. He was mentioning, walking down the stairs, how much fun everybody was having here outdoors. I know the rain has certainly put a damper on a lot of activities tonight, but it has not wavered this crowd's enthusiasm for the first ever AHL outdoor game in Bakersfield.
You know, at times during that second period, you just kind of had to laugh at what was unfolding on the ice. So, good to know that it hasn't dampened the spirits.
17-18 to go, third period. You hear the name Juge being thrown at. Jarkera gets it back to the point. Great ice mics here for this outdoor class. Our thanks to PacWest Impact Video for all they did to put this on tonight. Russell, shot blocker save made by Campbell. Condors with some chances here. LaLegia was tripped up in the left wing corner. Stays in on the forecheck. Knock down Russell. Russell in the right wing corner. Russell behind the net. LaLegia picked the puck and trying to throw it in front. It was knocked down. Russell stays on the forecheck. LaLegia had to hop over his tape. It's another one-goal game, Barts, outdoors in the American Hockey League. 7 of the 8 have finished one-goal games, including last year in Stockton. Against Stockton in Sacramento. Rolling puck and Campbell able to field it like a shortstop.
Let's hope that means the Condors have two more goals in them here. Try to give these somewhat wet fans here something to go home extra happy about.
16:26 to go in the third. We will have one media timeout. It will come
this line back out here for the Condors. Beck and Hamilton, by the way, 1-2 on this team, not just in points, but also in plus minus. Beck at plus 12 this season already. Hamilton at plus 10 now.
Beck with a three-game point streak, of course. That spanned a couple of weeks. Does have 7 points in his last three games. To go in the third period. Slapashev over the blue line. Beck right circle or a shot off the leg of McDermott and a rebound. Poke check wide by Ryan Hamilton. This line's starting to feel it. Half wall, it's Hamilton. Celebrated his daughter Madeline's second birthday yesterday with his family here at the outdoor class. 15:50 to go in the third period. Daughter Madeline born yesterday, 2 years ago. Wife Alexa born on New Year's Day. So two birthdays this week. 15:40 to go, third period. Puck up the left wing boards. Back on the backhand. Dropped it off. Frazier will scoop at the center. Slepyshev throws his shoulder into Scuderi.
out in front of the penalty boxes. Neutral zone. Dropped off there. It's Curry over the blue line with speed. Josh Curry has shot a blocker save. Made by Campbell, and the rebound is kicked all the way out through center. Played there by Mark Fink. 15:08 to go, third frame. Condors with some good looks here. Ice looks very good here in the third period.
Yeah, it really does. I mean, it looks nice and crisp, and maybe we're used to the game being slowed down in that second period, but the guys on both sides look like they're flying here in the third.
Under 15 to go, third period. Puck to the neutral zone. Curry knocked it down. Sent it in deep. Leslie, D to D. Leontinami up the left wing over the blue line. Carried there by Kempe. Shot off a body and out of play. 14:36 to go, third period. Goals in this game. Brett Sutter, Justin Auger for Ontario, Mark Fain for the Condors. For Sutter is 8th. For Auger is 7th. And for Fain is 1st.
Mark Fain, we talked about him a lot early in the broadcast as having just been sent down and only a handful of less than 10 games in Condorstown in his Bakersfield Condors career. Hit two outdoor games already. Good to see him get on the board with a nice shot.
14:32 remaining, third period. It's a 2-1 Ontario lead. The Condors are getting a goal here early in the third. Up the stick. Up Mark Fain for the right point. Puck battle for deep in the Bakersfield zone. 14:16 to go, third frame. Purcell. Turned back into his own zone. Leontinami. In the neutral zone for Purcell. His pass broken up. Potter shipping forward. Pass to Brady Christie. Puck goes down to the Ontario zone. We're in the dark blacks. Over the stick of Michael Mersch. Picked up there by Jajar Carey. Seal D to D. Mark Frazier. Outlet pass. Here's Kerr out in front of us. Down the right wing with speed. Jajar Kerr stops. To the high slot, Lalesia. He'll dip to the bottom right circle. Throw it in front. And Kerr had his stick lifted. Fain in the left circle. Threw it back towards the slot. Over the stick of Lalesia. Bouncing puck through center. Mark Frazier had it knocked down there. Puck comes through center ice. Fain knocked it down. Played back. Into the Ontario zone. 13:18 to go, third period. Let's go, Condors. The chant for the crowd behind us. On the backhand, Crescenzi in front tipped in, and Bressois made the stop. Picked up behind the net by his roommate, a BC native, Jajar Carey. 13 minutes remain, third period. It's 2-1 Ontario. Frazier in front of his own net to Taylor Beck. Gains the red line on the backhand over the blue. Slepyshev will chase it after. Slepyshev collides along the end boards. Sutter got a stick in there. Hamilton knocked it down. Behind the net for Beck. Beck in the left wing corner. Beck dancing with it. Able to shake off one man. Couldn't shake off a second. Slepyshev wins the battle for the puck. Behind the net for Beck. Beck in the left wing corner. Beck with some room here. Now behind the net and a poke check off his stick, but he leads for Slepyshev. Slepyshev pass back door. Hit a body and deflected to the right corner. Off the ledge, knocked down by Beck, took a hit up high, and then went hard into the glass, and then Auger was drilled by Slepyshev. Over the blue line, it's dumped in deep by Ontario, but quickly on the up, and the outlet pass through center. That was Brodzinski playing it, back for Skinnerd. Rob Skinnerd will climb the dots, skates the red line with 12:04 to go, third period. Puck to the left half off, shot, stick save made by Laurent Bressois. Under 12 to go in the third. 2-1 Ontario. Pass in front, shooting! And another stop from Bressois as he got a piece of that one and went up and out of play with 11:50 to go in the third period. Then the net came off the moorings.
That long stretch of uninterrupted play here during this third period. And, you know, good flow here to this third period as well. The Condors still trying to come from behind. They need just one more to get this thing tied up. But certainly the clock, one of the Condors' enemies here in this third stanza.
11:51 to go, third period. A 2-1 Ontario lead here from the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic. Down the right wing, Scott Allen. Dropping there, Platzer on the back ball. Took a bump from Leslie. Platzer, two goals outdoors last year in Sacramento. Backhand in front of the doorstep, Platzer bounced in, and that one just went wide.
Condors on the doorstep with a grind line with Allen. Out there, center, Musil will play. D to D, Mark Fain. Condors might be one defenseman short here. I have not seen Jordan Osterlund. Over the blue line, down the left wing comes Backman. Backman shot, knocked down, and then the secondary effort off the stick of the LaRopera swap. Shots are 24 each. Strong play from Musil. And they call the loose. Out to the center for Curry. Leachinami. D to D for Vincent Loverty. Rain bust in over the blue line. Left wing circle, stick handling. With Purcell. Back to the left point. Leachinami shot wide. Got past Latta and out to the center. Puck back up the left wing side. Onside is Hensick. Hensick on the backhand. Shot wide of the net. Hensick scoops it back up in the right wing corner. TJ Hensick, and that shot deflected up and out of play with 10:30 to go. Third period. 2-1 Ontario.
No rest for the Condors after this game here tonight. Back in action on home ice at Rabobank Arena this coming week, Tuesday and Friday.
Condors trail 2-1 with under 10:30 to go, third period. Brian Holt and Kevin Barno with you. AHL Live at KGET.com. Thanks for sticking with us from the Outdoor Classic. It's been memorable. And the puck covered up by Brassois off the faceoff in the Condors defensive zone. Ontario scored two goals in a monsoon. The Condors getting one here in the third.
Yeah, they really did. And one of those technically came in the first period of
yes.
play. After a delay. I might add as well that about 4 minutes left or so in the first period, there was a delay on one of the stanchions. They sent the teams to the dressing room.
I forgot
they were
that.
Having a hard time fixing it. But I bet they weren't even all the way to the dressing room yet before the stanchion actually got fixed. So maybe a little premature sending the guys up for the end of that period.
10-11 to go, third frame. If nothing at all, Condors are everywhere on social media right now. One point, it's Osterley. Highlights everywhere. Osterley is out there. Musil shot, blocker save made by Campbell. That was a heavy shot for the Moose.
That was a heck of a save, too, by Campbell. That baby was moving and had some movement on it.
Latta to center ice. Musil runs into him. Slepyshev cuts back. Excuse me, Russell. Deep in the Condors defensive zone. Osterley. And a tussle in the right wing corner. Ontario working low. Osterley. Still down with Hare. Hare comes back to the point. The pass picked off. Here come the Condors with speed. Up the right wing at the end of a shift. And Russell will dump deep. Line change for the Condors. 9:14 remaining, third period. Turnover force. Reinhardt shot off a stick and out of play. That was Sutter who came all the way out to get to that one. 9:09 to go, third period. We'll step out, take a break. Back with the Outdoor Classic. And the conclusion next. KGT and AHLLive.com.
And we're back here at the Condorstown Outdoor Classic here, 2-1 Ontario. Bakersfield trying to make a comeback. Check out the glass. See how clear it is here even after all the rain. Had to squeegee it off right. I want to show you some video, though, that we shot the other day of how they keep this glass so clear. They're using anti-fog solution. Incredible stuff. They had to squeegee it on. Really helped making this experience good for all the fans that are sitting up in the crowds. Ryan, Kevin?
Thank you very much, Jason. Yes, certainly. Glass work being all clear tonight. This game was ready to roll. Rain in the second period to damper things a bit, but it's 2-1 here. We got a hockey game with 8:45 to go in the third. Do the Condors have a late one? Ryan Holt, Kevin Barnell here with you. Bouncing puck for center. We got Jason Galvin ringside. Full post-game reaction up on Condors.tv. Over the blue line, it's Hamilton. Dropping, high slot, Slepyshev shooting, and a save by Campbell. It's on Slepyshev for the high slot, nearly knotted this one.
And a nice save by Campbell yet again, with number 12 breathing down his neck out there as well. Hamilton right on the doorstep. You know that he wants one here. By the way, during the last stoppage, I heard the music and didn't know where she was. The cameras here found Dancing Granny in the stands somewhere at BC.
A legend. Phyllis Hansen, Dancing Granny. Dances to Cotton Eye Joe each and every game. 8:20 to go third period. 2-1 Ontario. Bouncing puck to center. Tepic over the blue line, turn it over. Kyle Platzer dodged back, threw it out through center again. Down the right wing, Curry. Curry dropped it off, high slot Allen. Allen left circle, shot and a save by Campbell. 8:02 remaining third period.
And the clock just keeps going here, and the Condors playing well here. This third period's been very entertaining. A lot of fast-moving play. Both teams getting some chances. We've seen some good stops by both goaltenders as well. Campbell, though, kind of stealing the show here in the third period, trying to send the Condors fans home wanting. 26 saves in this game so far for the former first-round draft pick.
Shot in off a leg. Ontario bounces to center. Frazier, pass cross ice broken up by Auger. Auger, who has the, well, would-be game winner tonight. Back in the second, unassisted from the right circle over the shoulder of Brassois. Came out of a puddle. Antoniemi all the way back. Curry on the forecheck. 7:36 to go in the third. Bouncing puck out through center. Purcell had it knocked off his stick. Back to the Condors blue line. Mark Fain, the goal scorer. Outlet pass. LaLeggia on the backhand gets it deep. Russell in the right corner for LaLeggia. LaLeggia back right point. Here's Fain cross ice. Musil has it. Back for Fain. Bouncing puck. Wrist shot through traffic. Turned aside by Campbell. Back to the point and out through center. Kara will track it down. .655 to go third period. Neutral zone. Chip forward by Musil. And offsides the call against the Condors with 6:45 left. The Condors are getting good looks, especially moving the puck a little high to the point shot.
Yeah, they are. And another good look just moments ago for Mark Fain finding the netminder with the puck through traffic again. And that's one thing that really separates defenders, you know, from that getting to that upper level of the pro game. You have to be able to get your shots through. You have to find a way to get shots through traffic and in on the netminder. It's such a big part of the game these days, that low to high mentality, getting it out, getting some open space, and getting shots on goal.
Bouncing puck, Condors pick it up left point, throw it to the left circle, shooting, Taylor back to the save aid by Jack Campbell.
Boy, he's the guy you want with the puck on a stick, down all by himself in the left circle. Nice save again by Campbell.
Right half wall, it's back pass, but off a leg. It's over the 20-yard line and into the right-wing corner. Knocked down by Latta. There's Hamilton on the forecheck. Bump from behind the net from Beck. It comes up the wall. Osterle will all the way back out to center to retrieve. Under 6 to go, third period. A 2-0 on, or 2-1 Ontario lead over the blue line. Slepyshev avoided the hit. His center got all glass. I know. He was right out in front of us. On the back wall, the forecheck comes from Allen. The left wing, Sutter. On the back hit off the leg of Platter, forced a turnover. A shot in a stick, and it's Campbell made the stick save.
Puck just wobbling that time. Wouldn't sit down. Unfortunate break for the Condors.
Frazier holds in right point of the field. Clear gets that straight away. Musil. Left circle. Platter shot. Tip save Campbell. Rebound in the left corner. Platter over his stick. Musil keeps in. Platter holds. High slot Curry. On the backhand. Platter. Down to the left wing corner. Threw it in front off a skate of hell. And bouncing puck. Picked up. It's skated to center by Bronzinski. With speed. Trying to get away from Fain. Mark Fain back up the left wing. Curry. Platter. Held up. LaLeggia to his own zone. Musil. Outlet feed off the skate. Jajar Kara. 4:47 to go in the third. Condors get a goal from Mark Fain to pull them within one earlier this period. Puck chip pass LaLeggia. All the way down, and now Kempe and Kara barking at one another. Kara holds up with the attacking blue for Russell. Wrist shot over the blocker of Campbell. Top of the left circle, Osterley. To the left wing corner, pass broken up. Tipped just wide by Kara, cutting to the front of the net. Condors hold in right wing corner. Now up the left wing wall for Laverty. 4:14 to go in the third. 2-1 rain on this Saturday night outdoors at Memorial Stadium. And where you get a whistle and a stoppage in play offsides against Ontario. The attendance of tonight's 12,330. And our thanks to each and every one who certainly made their way out to the Outdoor Classic tonight. 12-3-3-0.
I gotta think if the weather had held up, there's probably many people back at home afraid to brave the rain. But thank you to everybody for coming out and making this such a memorable night.
Puck in the right way corner, it's Slapyshev. Slapyshev cycling down to the right way corner with Hamilton. Hamilton kicked to the stick, Slapyshev behind the net. Slapyshev to the left wing corner. Pass broken up from Taylor Beck. Expect to see this line a lot here in the final 3:38. Condors looking for the late tire. High slot, pass broken up. Condors turn it back up ice with speed. Down the right wing with Taylor Beck. Beck cut off at the last minute. A huge play from Crescenzi.
Yeah, really nice play by him. Angling off a very talented hockey player who tried to shrink it down.
Used all of a 6-5 frame. Now the Allen line comes out. Allen trying to chase after Crescenzi. He gets away from him. 3:13 to go, third period. Bressois out of his net to play it. It's trapped in the left wing corner. Condors will come through the neutral zone. Down the right wing with Curry. Over the blue line. Josh Curry in the right wing corner. Cycling with it. Can the Condors get one lead here? Left wing corner, it's Platzer. They trail it 2-1 with 2:54 to go in the third. We'll keep an eye on Bressois. He hasn't gone yet. On the back wall, it's Allen. Allen drops it off, it's Curry. Curry holding. Let's go Condors, the champ from the over 12,000. Many have remained. At the left point, it's Frazier. In the slot, bouncing puck. A legal hand pass in the defensive zone. Decibels pick it up here. Curry along the back wall, Allen. Allen has it tied up. On the backhand, it's Laverty. Up the wall, Musil. Got it down past Sutter. Behind the net, Allen. Allen holding it, stick handling. Behind the net. Allen on the backhand. At the side of the cage, dropped it off Curry. Back to, he scores! Josh Curry has tied it at 2.
Oh, Mr. Clutch for the Condors with it behind the cage. Look at the shot. He's got no angle. He just comes out, puts it in on goal, and it finds daylight behind Campbell. And the Condors, late third period dramatics.
Josh Curry, a flair for the dramatic in front of over 12,000 here at the Outdoor Classic. This place is rocking. 2:04 to go, third period, and Curry has tied us at 2 unassisted. Now, a brand new hockey game. Outdoors, Auger flips it in. Bressois gloves it. A third period, a comeback for the ages.
You gotta love it. You gotta love it. And Josh Curry making it happen, getting a hold of that loose puck. Behind the cage, trying to decide what to do with it. Faked one way, got just enough daylight off the near post to hook it back and beat Campbell to that position. He left just a little bit. He puts it off the goaltender and into the back of the net. And that was an exuberant Josh Curry and company as he ties it up.
You have to love this Condors team, the resiliency. They trailed 2-0 going to the third. They knew this would be a normal period, as normal as it got tonight, and they responded. Lalegi at the defensive blue line had it knocked off his stick. Puck bounces down to the Condor zone.
They've been the better team here in this third period. They've had a lot of jump.
Lalegi in the right corner. This place is loud. Lalegi bottom of the right dot.
Trying to come back for Osterley. Fell on top of the puck. Mersch stayed it over it. Kara, big body check on Michael Mersch. Clear it out, Sace. Yeah. Osterley rips one around.
The Condors want it. I mean, they are gutting this one out, beating them to lose.
Big puck. Hit on the forecheck from Patty Russell. Condors field it now. Here's Hamilton. A minute remaining in regulation. Up the right way, Grzeszczyk. Rysuana playing. What an atmosphere here late. 49 seconds left in regulation. Bouncing puck to center, Hamilton. Wide for Beck. Delays over the blue line. Taylor Beck through the legs. He was held up. No call coming. Side of the cage. Shot from Hamilton. And a save made by Campbell with Slepyshev there at 36.2 to go into third. How fun is it?
It's a lot of fun. And this line just continues what's gone on. Line after line, shift after shift. And a timeout here for the Condors. Called by the Condors,
yeah,
with the top line out in the offensive zone. I love it. I love it.
An outdoor game in AHL history. Three games have gone to overtime. Last one in 2013. Wilkes-Barre Scranton beat Hershey at Hershey Park Arena. That was also at a football stadium.
Yeah, well, I love the call here by Jerry Fleming and company to get the timeout, get his crew, and Fleming quick to jump right down to the dasher and huddle his boys up and get this one lined up because, and watch, I mean, the faceoff win is where this all starts. They must win the draw or else everything is out the window. But use that timeout. You have your top line out on the ice. The ice is fantastic. This line is feeling it. Get them the extra break. Get it lined up. Get it drawn up. Make it happen.
Face off to the right of Campbell. 36.2 to go. Beck in to take it. Playing center tonight. First time this season. Taylor Beck wins the draw. Left wing half wall. Beck to the left wing corner on the backhand. Tucked it off the dasher. Hamilton on the forecheck. Passed him. Sutter will chip it deep. An exciting finish on tap. Will it be in regulation or in overtime? 18 seconds to go. Hucked up deep. Hamilton on the forecheck. Left wing corner. Beck off his stick. And lifted high in the air with 5 to go. The Rain are going to head to an overtime for a league high 13th time. And here tonight, we're heading to overtime at the Outdoor Classic.
It's not enough. 60 minutes is not enough. Everyone wants more fun.
It's the first ever 3-on-3 overtime in AHL outdoor history. Of course, that rule being put into place last 2 years.
2-2, and got ourselves a fantastic finish. I feel like we've seen a little bit of everything already here in this hockey game. We've braved the elements. We've had some fantastic hockey. Some good goaltending here tonight as well. And Condors up over 30 shots on goal here in this game, 32-26 through regulation. Allen and Musil, by the way, had the assists on that goal.
Yeah, they ended up giving the assist to Allen Musil. And the three-way
equalizer.
Chevrolet. Condors Town Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank is going to overtime. For the Condors, 2-4 in OTs this year. But they force OT, trailing by 2 goals, entering the third period. They've done that on 3 of 10 occasions. They have not won when trailing after 2 this year. They haven't won when not scoring the opening goal of the game. They haven't played in a monsoon until tonight. A lot can end here this evening. LaLegia, Kara, Osterling, Kempe, Ledoux, and Michael Mersch. You can hear the Condors bench. A lot of chatter there. They were the better team in the third. They know it. The team switch ends. 3-on-3 overtime. Condors with a lot of speed. A lot of skill. The Rain with the bigger lineup here to start the overtime session. Kara and Kempe at center ice. Puck is down. Game is on and overtime is off and running here at the Outdoor Classic. Osterley for LaLegia. LaLegia dropping. Osterley to center. Puck poked off his stick. Crowd is feeling it. Nobody has sat down. Kara over the blue line. High slot delays. Left circle holding. Kara cuts. Comes all the way back, dropping for Osterley. Osterley shot in front, knocked out. Redirect effort turned wide by LaLegia. Bouncing puck to the left wing corner. Condors will battle for it there. It comes up the wall. Out through center, Mersch. Two on one against Griffin Reinhardt. Michael Mersch to the circle. Mersch holding, pivoting, can't get the shot up. Reinhardt stripped him of the puck. Back the other way. Griffin Reinhardt down the left wing. On goal, shooting and scores! Griffin Reinhardt in overtime!
What a play by Reinhardt! Showing some speed, getting behind the defenseman, and makes no mistake, Reinhardt ends it. Caps a brilliant outdoor comeback for the Condors here tonight.
Griffin Reinhardt on the breakaway beats Jack Campbell, and the Condors come from two goals down in the third period to stun the Ontario Reign. Go crazy, Condorstown! That was a classic! We're going to try and get Griffin Reinhardt for the post-game interview here. Down a bedside with Jason Galvin. I think they have somebody mic'd up down there, but we'll keep an eye out for Jason Galvin. Certainly try and get the post-game interview with the Jason. As Griffin Reinhardt waiting to get off the ice. Got a lot of three stars tonight. But what a finish. And what a guy to get the goal here in the overtime with Griffin Reinhardt.
Yeah, the big cat. I mean, he shows off a lot of speed. I never saw it coming. And neither did the D. He gets around the defenseman, makes a very forward-esque move to get around the D-man. Uses his body position. Look at the way he comes in. Rifles it home.
We're going to get to Griffin Reinhardt down to ringside. Jason Galvin, I believe, has the big cat. Griffin Reinhardt for his post-game at Dramatics, the overtime game winner with the Jason Galvin down to ringside at the Condors of player title. Jason with the OT hero. How about it, Jason?
And we're here on the ice with Griffin Reinhardt, the game-winning goal in overtime. What an incredible comeback for you guys. But first, take me through that breakaway.
It's kind of a one-on-one battle. I mean, I get a position. It started in the D zone. You know, puck was bouncing a little bit. I saw it and took advantage of it.
What were your thoughts when you saw that going in?
Well, I mean, I had a good chance in the second period there, and you know, it was pretty wet, didn't get that chance, so it was nice that one of them went in.
This is an incredible experience. You guys played through a torrential downpour for Bakersfield, and then to battle back in the third period there. What was the key for you guys tonight?
We stuck with it. We kept it simple. The ice wasn't the best condition in that second period, and we weathered the storm there. We've been in this position a lot. We've lost a lot of overtime games, so it's nice being on the other end.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Griffin Reinhardt with the game-winning goal there for the Condors. What a night! A win in overtime. Holte, Bartle, can you believe it? How about a breakaway from the big defenseman there to win it at the end? That's just incredible.
We call him the big cat, Griffin Reinhardt. We'll send it to break when we come back. We'll have the post-game show. We'll wrap it up here from the three-way Chevrolet Condors Town Outdoor Classic. Bart, stop eating! It's the magic of the pulled pork!
That must have been it.
It's the pulled pork. Condor scored three goals since we had a snack. We'll be back with the post-game show. Bakersfield 3, Ontario 2. Reinhardt with the OT winner. Don't go anywhere. Your home of the Condors, the Town Outdoor Classic, KGT 17.
The Condors Town Outdoor Classic. Sponsored by Bakersfield College.
Welcome back to Bakersfield College Memorial Stadium. In front of a crowd of over 12,300, the Bakersfield Condors
beat the Ontario rain. They weathered the storm, as Griffin Reinhardt said, literally and figuratively. They trail 2-0 after two periods of play. They score twice in the third. And then they score the overtime winner with one of the unexpected goal scorers for a 3-on-3 overtime, especially the way it happened. Reinhardt on a breakaway to cap an incredible comeback. The first time this year the Condors have won when not scoring the opening goal of a game. It was more than that tonight, Parts. There must have been something, I don't know, in the water.
Well, I think of the 12,000, and obviously it goes without saying, but the largest crowd, a home crowd in Condors history here. But I think everybody going home extra happy. I mean, what an experience this was here tonight. Great atmosphere in this building. Even when it was raining, people having fun, players smiling at us getting rained on just 3 feet away from us on the glass. And to cap a comeback like this in the third period just sends everybody home happy. I hope everybody got as much of a kick out of it as we did bringing it to you here and being a part of something like this. And this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
This was something incredible. This was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. It was something that we may never witness. The rain, everything going on here in Condorstown, but made it happen.
You'll never see a second period like that again. I feel safe in saying that.
And our thanks, I see some of the Oilers dignitaries and their personnel coming down. Craig McTavish giving us a big fist pump. Our thanks to all the Oilers and Kings alumni and all the celebrities that came out this weekend, made everyone's weekend on Friday nights. The NHL Alumni Celebrity Game, it could not have gone better. It was a fantastic evening. The Condors certainly gave everyone their money worth here tonight. I mean, we are completely hoarse. I mean, my voice is completely gone. That's how you know you had fun. And again, with the weather, we got through it. And we had a classic. We had an outdoor classic.
It was a classic,
here
no
at
doubt.
Memorial Stadium. For Jason Galvin, Tabitha Mills, Nick James, the rest of the 17 crew, from all of us here on site at Memorial Stadium, it's Kevin Bartle. I'm Ryan Holt. I hope you enjoyed the three-way Chevrolet Condorstown Outdoor Classic presented by Mission Bank as much as we did. But for now, we're signing off. The final score, Bakersfield Condors 3, Ontario Rain 2, in a classic outdoors at Memorial Stadium. Good night, everybody.